and the Kansas City Blades have always had great battles together, and tonight should be no different. From the Summit in Houston, Texas, it's another Western Conference battle as the Houston Aeros host the Kansas City Blades. A very pleasant good evening and welcome to the Summit. I'm Adam Gordon. The Aeros picking up a big win Sunday over the Phoenix Roadrunners 5-0, and they did it in fine fashion, picking up their first shutout ever in franchise history at the Summit. And as I bring in my broadcast partner, Troy Gamble, everybody played very well, but we got to start with the net mining, and Freddie Shabbat looks like he's starting to get comfortable with the Summit surroundings.
Well, the one thing Frederick Shabbat did is that he had his angles covered all game. He did that very well, and he gets a shutout from it. But in his last 8 games at the Summit, Adam, he has a 2.77 goals against average and a 9.10 save percent. You cannot ask too much more from Frederick Shabbat. He's done all that he could at home the last 8 games.
And with Frederick Shabbat playing well, you expect the other guys to pick it up, the Mark Lambs, the Gary Shuchuks, but I thought the guy that was the real spark plug, who only saw limited ice, was Moose Morissette.
Well, he got into that big fight at the start of the game, and then he had some crushing checks during the game. That gave him the opportunity to have a little more ice time. So what does Dave Morissette do? He scores likely the prettiest goal all season. He does a spinorama, throws it in 5-hole. What a goal by Dave Morissette, a guy who you don't expect to score that much, but what a goal it was.
And you talk about the elements that Dave Morissette brings to the Aeros. It's those exact same qualities that Doty Wood brings to the Kansas City Blades.
Well, this guy is so tough. He plays for the San Jose Sharks. He's down on a conditioning assignment right now. Played a couple games in Quebec, has 4 points in 2 games. But what happens, Adam, is that when you're that tough, you get a lot of extra room. Quebec gave him a lot of room. Don't look for the Aeros to give him that much room tonight.
Yeah, the Blades are in the midst of an 8-game swing here, and the Blades are hoping to have Doty Wood for those 8 games, but the scoring doesn't come from Doty Wood. It comes from 2 veterans that they've had from since their start, David Bruce and Gary Emmons.
Well, as the Kansas City Blades go, so does David Bruce and Gary Emmons. David Bruce leading them in goals with 7 goals. Gary Emmons leading them in points with 15. One thing about Gary Emmons is that in 392 games, he has 393 points, and that is just spectacular. He's been a career Kansas City Blade player.
It's time for another edition of the GGP, the Gamble game plan. The defensive zone coverage was terrific Sunday night against the Phoenix Roadrunners. That has to continue tonight.
Well, I thought that set the tempo. I had a chance with Mark Lamb to sit down and look at the defensive zone coverage. I believe that's how they got all the offensive chances they did. They were so good in their own end of the ice, and if they continue with that tonight, they're going to get a lot of chances. Passing. The passing was tape to tape, Adam. It was likely the best passing I've seen the Aeros do all year. They did not have to break stride, and that gave them team speed. When you have that team speed, other opposing defenses are going to back off. That's what happened. Keep it going. They have to keep that team speed going, that passing going. If they keep things simple, like Dave Tippett wants them, they're going to have some success.
Dave Tippett, prior to the Sunday game, he kept it very simple, had a very short comment to write on the chalkboard, a very similar comment put up there tonight. We'll see if it has any effect when we return the opening faceoff, the Aeros and the Kansas City Blades from the Summit. Houston Aeros Hockey on Fox Sports Southwest, brought to you by Southwest Airlines. With fares so low, you have the freedom to go places. By your participating Texas Chrysler, Plymouth, Dodge, and Jeep and Eagle dealers. By Columbia Healthcare Corporation. Healthcare has never worked like this before. By Texaco Clean System 3 Gasolines. Add more life to your car. Take it to the star. By Hilo Auto Supply. For the lowest prices every day, what you need is Hilo. And by the Gatorade Company. You live life, you get thirsty. Life's a sport, drink it up. Pleasant good evening. Welcome to the Summit. Adam Gordon, Troy Gamble. We get set for the Aeros and the Kansas City Blades. And let's take a look at tonight's starting lineups, brought to you by Southwest Airlines. At center, Jason Cerrone with David Bruce and John Purvis on the wings. Defensively, Jim Kite and Norman Rochefort. Now, not many people realize this, but the Blades have 2 superstars on their team. And we start in goal. Adam Sandler will start in goal. That's Philip DeRouville. 4-4-3, but does he not look like Adam Sandler? And I said there were 2 superstars. On bench as the assistant coach, Phil Collins. Take a look at me now. Okay, no, it's Lucien Devoir, but Troy, do those two not look like Adam Sandler and Phil Collins?
I tell you, you picked those guys out so quick, Adam, it's unbelievable.
Unbelievable. Prince will be our referee tonight. No, just kidding. Let's take a look at the starting lineups for the Houston Aeros, brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Mike Hurlbut on defense, along with Dave Basigio up front. Mike Yeo, Gary Shuchuk, and Al Conroy. And making another start at home after that brilliant 5-0 shutout, Frederick Chabot. And a 3.22 goals against average. It's amazing. He was 3.46 prior to Sunday's game, but amazing what a shutout does to your numbers.
Well, when you get those big zeros, all of a sudden your average and your save percent go in different directions. Average goes down, save percent goes up.
The Aeros have won 5 of the last 6 against the Blades. They've played very well against Kansas City, but you might recall that 2 years ago it was the Larry Dick show, but Larry Dick has gotten off to a slow start this year, and Philip DeRouville has come in and done a terrific job since being loaned to them by the Pittsburgh Penguins. The Aeros have the puck at center, and Basigio will fling it into the Kansas City zone. DeRouville will wind it along the boards. Firstweiler tried to knock it down. It came back out at center. Hurlbut fell. In there was Ian Boyce. He'll crank him to the wall. And play is whistled down. Just underway in a scoreless hockey game.
Mike Hurlbut, it almost looked like he got hit by a sniper the way he went down.
While we've got a minute, let's go downstairs to Rob Dobson. Rob, prior to the game, is it kind of a similar pregame speech as it was to Sunday's game?
Well, I think so. We want to build on that. We know that in order to become a better hockey club, we've got to build on past experience. And we haven't had much luck lately of winning a couple games in a row. And I think this is real important for our confidence level to take a step ahead as opposed back. And a big start tonight and a big win will help us get there.
All right. Thanks, Dauber. Off the faceoff, Hurlbut's got it. And it's rolled away. Bowler jammed it into the Kansas City zone. DeRouville knocked it down. Jim Kite flings it along the boards. Knocked down by Malasevic. Centered off the skates of Freer. Bowler rolled it down. Picked up by Freer. Got it back to the line. Basigio slides it for Freer. That's knocked away. And here come the Blades out at center. It's shot ahead by Norman Rochefort, but knocked back out at center ice. Blades regroup, and here is Paul Dick at center. Shoots the puck into the arrow zone. It came out in front, but the arrows are there, and they're out at center. Mark Freer winds it up. A pass for Valasevic. Drive and a glove save made by DeRouville. Paul Dick behind the net. Give it to Dean Sylvester. Bumped along the boards by Freer. They dig it out. It's picked up by Bruce and shot out at center. David Bruce in the neutral zone. Fire the puck and arrow territory and after to Sylvester. Trying to get through the check of Kuchera. Now it's Bruce. Rolled it down for Sylvester. Emmons gives chase, but Kuchera has it for Houston. He'll move it up the boards and out at center. A minute and a half gone by in the opening period in a scoreless hockey game. Paul Dick goes back and an icing call on the Aeros.
Aeros just trying to dump it in. Frank Kuchera dumped it in before the red line. Dave Tippett, before the game, was really enthused about this game because they have to play the Kansas City Blades 2 times in 3 days. He feels that if they get off to a good start this game, that it could set the tempo for this 2-game series.
Ryan Fogarty, this is a guy that has bounced around a little bit. He was a guy that walked off the Minnesota Moose team last year, and he seems to be getting chances, but you know why? Those numbers right there, 2 goals, 9 assists, 11 points. That's why he keeps getting a lot of chances. He's a good offensive defenseman.
Well, he was Canadian Major Junior Player of the Year in 89. I believe he had 160 points for a defenseman.
Now Jason along the boards, cleared to the line. Fogarty held it in. Looked it down along the wall. In after it is Purvis. Aeros jump on it. That's Hurlbut in there. Jammed away, and the Aeros bring it out at center. A pass too far. Back are the Kansas City Blades. Paul Dick. Pass came over along the wall. Doty Wood cleared it. But the Blades give chase as Hurlbut back in his own end. Lamb turns it around. Mark Lamb lead pass into the Kansas City zone. Delayed offsides. And the Blades regroup. At center, Fogarty can't find the handle, and Paul Dick cleared to center. Mark Lamb in to get it. Lamb lost it. It's picked up. Here's the shot by Cerrone. Score! Jason Cerrone picked up a loose puck, and the Blades jump out to an early 1-0 lead.
What a blast by Jason Cerrone, startling Frederick Chabot. He put all of his muscle into this shot, blasts it from just inside the top of the circles. Off the far post, off the other post. What a blast. I'm not quite sure if it did not hit a stick. Frederick Chabot was out at the top of his crease, but Cerrone just beat him far side.
Well, Jason Cerrone picks up his first goal as a Kansas City Blades. He has a goal and 3 assists for 4 points. In his first seven games as a Kansas City Blade, he was acquired in the trade that sent Jeff Cirka to Long Beach. Puck is back out at center ice as the Blades take a 1-0 lead. And Kuchera goes back. Kuchera takes his man to the boards. He had bumped Culleton there, and the Arrows move it out. Al Conroy, a pass for Yo. We've got a whistle, and I thought Culleton got clipped with a high stick from Kuchera behind the play. It was inadvertent, but I think if you go back and look at Kuchera taking Culleton to the boards, I think Kuchera caught him with a high stick, and that might be a penalty. I don't know if they're going to call it.
I believe they're going to call it. I think they're discussing whether to call it the 2-minute high sticking, the 4-minute high sticking, or the 5-minute high sticking. Well, the way that eye looks, that could be a 5-minute high sticking.
That was clearly an inverted, but watch Kuchera as he went to lift the stick, play the puck, and then whack, right?
Well, Kuchera goes to lift his stick, but he misses his stick and comes directly up above the left eye, knocks his helmet back. Well, Kuchera's going to the box, so he's not getting a 5-minute major. We know that for sure. Now it's just going to be either 2 or 4.
4 minutes up on the board to Kuchera, and not the start the Arrows had in mind.
And no, not the start, but that is one of the rules now, that before, if you drew blood at all, it was automatic 5 in a game. Now they say if it was inadvertent, you get 4 minutes and you don't get the game misconduct.
Faceoff will be at center as Kansas City will go on the power play. And it is a double minor to Kuchera as they announce it. The Kansas City Blade power play is not too good at 11.8%. That's 17th in the IHL. The Arrows penalty killing slowly climbing. It is now over in the 80s at 80.9%.
And in the last 7 games, they've killed off 34 of 38 for 89.5%, which is great.
The signs of a turnaround. As Shabbat comes out of the net, and Masigio played it for Houston, rolled it back to the line, Fogarty held it in. Shot it down for Purvis, Freer in a battle along the boards. It came down for Cerrone, who has the Kansas City goal in this game. Cody Wood to the corner, trying to get through the Jenks check. It came behind the net for John Purvis. And anytime you talk about Purvis in the power play, you can do it in one breath. They are both very volatile. Purvis rolled it down. Wood, watched by Masigio, gives it to Purvis, got it back along the boards. 3:19 left to the Kuchera double minor. Claudio Stremmen to the right point. Tied up and bumped by Alan May. Rolled the puck down low for Purvis. He fights the puck to the corner. Wood centered it, but Al May was there, and he'll shoot it down the ice. Philip DeRuel out of the net with 3:03 to go in the Kuchera double minor. 1-0 Kansas City, 16.5 to play in the opening period. David Bruce at center, across the line, that is offsides, and the faceoff comes back to center. 16:20 to go, first period, 1-0 Kansas City.
And Purvis has been one of those players that has only scored 3 goals this year. It's kind of been a mystery. Last year, 105 points in San Francisco, had 54 goals, second to Craig Fisher. But we talked to Doug Sotar, both me and you, Adam, and he said he believes the goaltending is getting not much stronger in the IHL.
Well, and you know, we were talking to Doug Sotar kind of about the Arrows problems where they had those 187 shots in 4 games and couldn't pick up a win. He says, that's our story too. We work hard, we put ourselves in a position to play, and we just can't get breaks, and the goaltending has been terrific. I mean, it sounds almost exactly like the Arrows story. Off the faceoff, the Arrows have it, Pearl, but cranked it out at center, and the Blades regroup at neutral ice. Ryan Stacey had it taken away, shoot, Chuck shorthanded. He dropped it for Conroy, who didn't read the play. It was a miscommunication. It's not that Conroy didn't read, I think they just miscommunicated. And it's picked up along the boards. Craigwell back to the line. Craigwell got it back along the board, scooped it down, puck centered, stopped along the wall as that was bumped by Wawrinka. Give it to Craigwell. Dale Craigwell scooped it down for Ian Boyce. Looped it back to the line as it was held in by Paul Dick. Here is Boyce to the line. Dick lets his shot go. That was wide. Shabbat trying to knock it down. It's cleared over to the near boards. Ian Boyce slides it down. Tell you what, Blades move the puck pretty good here. Real quick passing. Boyce behind the net. Looks in front. Boyce waiting. Had it knocked. knocked away by Orwenka. Cerrone came in to have a look at it. Aldick pinching. The arrow is clearing, and it's out at center and back into the Blade zone. 1:52 to go to Kuchera. 15:18 to go in the first. 1-0 Blades.
Very good job by the Arrows killing off that first 2 minutes. Very aggressive. They stayed in their box, but they were aggressive when they had to be to get the puck all the way down.
Blades shoot the puck down. It's icing. If Basigio gets there, he will. And that'll bring the puck back down into the Kansas City zone and a faceoff in the Blades end.
Dave Basigio, who in 16 games has 4 goals, 8 assists, 12 points. But in 12 games with the Arrows, he has 4 goals, 8 assists, 12 points. So you can tell how much of an asset he's been for the Arrows. And he has points in 9 out of his 12 games, Adam. And as Dave Basigio goes, I think the defense has really went.
He's no question been the definite spark for the Arrow defense since coming in. And his level of play has raised the level of play of others on the bench.
And he's fourth in the IHL in scoring with defense, but he's a +7, but a +6 at home in the Summit.
Faceoff left side of Deruville. Bill Bowler out to kill off the penalty with Mike Yeo. Yeo a shot off the skates of Bowler as Yeo returning to the lineup after missing a couple of games with a groin pull. Blades pick up a loose puck. Gary Emmons out at center. Emmons a pass for Sylvester. Shoots it in. It's gloved by Chabot. Chabot trying to clear it. He shot it right to Sylvester. Booms it along the boards for David Bruce. 1:19 to go in the power play. Back to the line. Scrum and lost it. Bowler off to the races. He's hauled down on a penalty coming up to Kansas City. Bowler got by Bruce and Scrum, and we'll take a timeout as they sort everything out. 1-0 the Blades back after this. But first, this word from Southwest Airlines. Blades lead it 1-0 as a penalty to Claudio Scrimm, and the Arrows did a good job on that Kansas City power play for the better part of 3 minutes. No shots on goal.
Well, the puck jumps over Scrimm's stick, and what Bill Bowler does, he keeps his feet moving, and he forces Claudio Scrimm to haul him down. Very good play by Bill Bowler that, after noticing the puck jumped over his stick, he went around to the outside and kept his feet moving, draws the 2-minute penalty.
Face-off will be in the Blade zone, top of the near circle. Freer with Floro's hurl button. Jakes at the line. Freer wins the draw, but it snaps back to center, and Jakes will regroup to his own blue line. LaRose, watched by Cerrone. He'll pop it ahead to center, and Freer is off to the races. Freer hits the line with LaRose as LaRose goes to the net. Here's Freer, shooting, stopping was Deruville. Puck back in front, turning, here's Jakes, backhander. Great glove save made by Deruville, and he'll hold on.
Deruville making a couple very good stops, first on Mark Freer, and then on Steve Jakes jumping on the rebound. He jumps on the rebound after a good shot by Mark Freer. You got to take those shots. Deruville goes down. Mark Freer with a good pass back to Steve Jakes. Steve Jakes trying to muscle it in on his backhand. Big glove save. Very wisely holds on to the puck.
Tough break that Jakes, the right-handed shot. Could have been nice if he was lefty, but Don Jackson, the head coach of the Kansas City Blades, happy with his team up 1-0.
And I thought it was very interesting, a graduate of Notre Dame, so you better not get into two arguments with that guy.
Off the draw, Kansas City's got it. Gary Emmons scampers out at center. Bring it across the line with Fogarty. Quick shot right on. Chabot stopped it. Puck out in front, and the Arrows are the other way. In about half a minute, the Arrows will be on their first power play of the night. Into the corner, LaRose, tied up by Paul Dick. Tied up by Freer. Worked it along the boards. Freer is tied up by David Bruce. They sweep along the wall, picked loose by Freer. Cuts to the slot. Freer with a lane, gives Hurlbutt the shot. Stopped by Deruville. Puck in front. They hit the side of the net. A great chance. Freer trying to center. He's hammered by Dick. LaRose behind the net. Comes right out. Shoots. Stopped in front. It's in skates. Jake's turning. Good shot is deflected by LaRose. The Arrows with all kinds of chances, but the Blades holding on. And then a hip check by Jakes, knocking Bruce down to the ice. Power play on for the Arrows for 49 seconds. 1-0 Kansas City. Great action here in the last couple of minutes. Puck is shot down into the Arrow zone. Basigio will go back. Mark Lamb has it for Houston. He'll wind it up and out of his zone. Lamb off the boards for Craig. It's loose at center. And Craig will go back. Hand it over to Basigio. Dave Basigio, give it to Mark Lamb. Puck goes into the Kansas City zone. Jim Kite in a battle with Craig. Craig lost it. Bowler trying to move it along as Kite gives him a bump, and Kite will clear it all the way down the ice.
The Arrows' power play is going to be in tough tonight. Last six games, they've killed off 19 of the straight penalties.
Now the power play down to 2 seconds as it's brought across the line by Mark Lamb. Lamb heading set, scooped it along for Bill Bowler. Pass, here's Wawenka, the really shot, and that was hooked wide of the net. Masiccio pinching, got it for Bowler behind the net, waiting, still looks for the pass, center the shot, hammered just wide as Lamb came smoking down the right side. Jim Kite for Kansas City, fired a puck up for Scrum, and it's blasted out at center. Mark Gregg can't advance it, and it's turned away. Craigwell, give it to Donnie Wood, tees it up, walks right in, shoots, scores! Donnie Wood, 5-0 on Shabbat, 2-0 Kansas City.
Doty Wood coming off the wing, very patient on Frederick Shabbat. He did not commit at all. Once Frederick Shabbat started dropping down in that low crouch position, he fires a wrist shot through the five hole, through the legs. He's very, very patient. He's looking five hole all the way as Frederick Shabbat drops down to take it into the midsection. Wood shoots the puck.
So
he's watching here, Adam. He's watching. I don't know if he thought Shabbat was going to go down, but obviously it looked like he was going five hole all the way.
So the Blades jump out to a 2-0 lead on Doty Wood's goal. And for Doty Wood, that is goal number 2 on the year, as they tend to a rut in the ice. 7, make it almost 8 minutes gone in this first period, and the Blades now lead it 2-0. Here is Tkachuk, May, and Morissette with Jenks and Kuchera. Off the face-off, the Blades have got it, and it goes deep for Brian Fogarty. Fogarty in behind the net, flushed out by Tkachuk. Puck came out in front, and the Blades clear. John Purvis moves it to center for Cerrone. Out of the net, it's Shabbat. Swings it along the boards, knocked down by Cerrone. Kuchera gives chase. Frank Kuchera, he'll move it up and out of his zone. Kuchera's pass is out to center ice for Gary Tkachuk. Kuchera across the line, lost it. Here comes Doty Wood at center ice, and he'll hand it over to John Purvis. Purvis across the line, trying to make his move, kicked away. It's loose in the slot. Blades have it. Stremmen winding, shooting, stopping Shabbat. Puck in front, and it's controlled by Purvis. Stremmen cuts it over, but it's out at center, and the Blades will regroup.
Obviously not the start that Dave Tippett and the Arrows really want here.
Well, Al Conroy will go back, and an icing call, and we take time out. Blades lead it 2-0, and we'll be back after this. Kansas City, and you talk about a battler, the face of battle, Al Conroy.
Al Conroy the other night taking 8 stitches below the eye, but the scary thing was, Adam, is that when the puck hit him in the eye, he just kept going. He didn't drop down. He just kept in on the play. You don't say hockey players are tough. Look at that eye and say that that guy's not tough.
I think he took the coach's advice of keeping his eye on the puck too literally. As the Arrows trail 2-0. Here is Hurlbutt, shot high and wide of the net. Chased down by Basigio. As it's jumped on Craigwell, and Tkachuk fight for it along the boards. Here is Gary Tkachuk, right side, looks in front. He's bumped by Brian Stacey. Puck to the corner for Yo. Mike Yo cuts in, stuff shot blocked. And it's shoveled out by Ian Boyce, and the Arrows go back. Dave Basigio in his own end. Cleared it to center, that's a 2-line pass, and the faceoff comes back into the Arrow end. Right now, the Arrow's just looking for Frederick Shabbat to settle down a little bit. It has not been a bad start for the guys up front. They put some pressure on Philip DeRouville, and another chance in front for Yo a moment ago. So maybe just get Shabbat to settle down and keep banging away, and they're going to get back in this thing.
Well, I'm sure Frederick's going to settle down, and Mike Yo in the last 6 games has 3 goals, 4 assists for 7 points. He missed those 3 games with the hip flexor. It doesn't look like he's really missing a beat out there tonight.
We had him on as an intermission guest.
What a beautiful baby. Oh,
isn't that unbelievable? Puck is back into the Kansas City zone. 2-0, the Blades lead it. Near is Jim Kite in his own end. Kite will move it up and out. Pass bounds out at center. And the Blades are in transition. Gary Emmons across the line. Poke check. Arrows trying to clear. It's in front. Here's a quick shot. Stuck aside by Schiavone. Bobbled it for just a second, but he was able to pounce on it. And he will hold on.
A one-on-one battle that the Arrows don't win. Very good save by Frederick Chabot to get down low. Arrows are going to have to regroup and start winning those one-on-one battles. That's a situation in the slot area. You have to make sure he cannot get that shot off. He ends up getting the shot off, and Frederick Chabot alertly covers up.
Face off, left side of Frederick Chabot. 2-0, the Blades lead it. And here is Jim Kite at the point. Kite shot, stuck aside by Chabot. To the point. Here's a shot stuck aside by Chabot. And Kucherov battles along the boards. And Bill Bowler gets it out at center for Rob Valasevic. Puck goes in and we've got a whistle as the Blades are offsides. Let's send it down to Rob Dobson. Dobbert, would you agree with the assessment that boys have come out and have played pretty well here in the early stage of this first period?
I think we have come up pretty good, but unfortunately we have a couple turnovers right here at the gray area at the blue line that allowed that one shot on Cerrone. And as a goalie, you want to get a fairly easy shot to start the game. We didn't, and then allowed a 2-on-1. But we've got to capitalize on our chances down there and clean up our own end just a little bit, and we're right back in the hockey game.
Yeah, guys seem like they're hopping pretty good.
And they're skating well. The defensive coverage and assignments are important. And more so important than here in the first period.
Thanks, Dobber. That brings up a point that we touched upon in the Gamble game plan, was that defensive zone coverage. We appreciate that from Rob Dobson. Puck goes in the Kansas City zone and out of the net, Durouville. But it's right over to Valasevic. Slips it down to the corner. Sylvester knocked it down, trying to clear. It's poked to the line, not out. Held in by Wawrinka. Wawrinka steers it down, kicked away though nicely by Jim Kite. And it's pushed to center ice for David Bruce. Bruce with Emmons and Sylvester, but Bruce fanned on the centering attempt, and the Arrows get it out at center. Bill Bowler, give it to Rob Valasevic. Across the line he comes, but that is offsides as Bowler was a stride or two ahead of the play. And the faceoff brought back outside the Kansas City zone. 9:23 to go in the first, 2-0 Kansas City.
Rob Valasevic, the only rookie on the Arrows, took a little too much time getting that puck dumped in. Dave Tippett likes it to get dumped in right away. What happens? He puts Bill Bullard offside. 12 games with the Arrows, 1 goal, 3 assists, 4 points. But the one thing Rob has really did, he has not made those rookie mistakes. Dave Tippett feeling very confident in Rob Valasevic and putting him out on the ice.
Well, a lot of credit goes to not only Rob Valasevic, but I think Dave Tippett and the way that Dave Tippett has brought Rob along. I mean, you know, sometimes a rookie can come in and say, I want to play, but they've used him sparingly, but each time his ice time is increased, he gets better. As a shot comes on, it was deflected by Mark Lamb. Mark Gregg to the corner. He's bumped by Cerrone, but Doty would able to clear it. It's back down the ice. 9 minutes to go in the first period. 2-0 Kansas City. Puck is in the arrow end. Jakes, a pass snapped ahead for LaRose. He gives chase to it. Out of the net, it's Durouville. It's cleared along the boards. Held in by Masiccio. Let's his shot go. That's ricocheted away. LaRose on the right wing boards, flies one down for Gregg. Tried to center when it was off the stick of Purvis, and the Blades come out at center. Cerrone for Purvis. That's knocked away by LaRose. Now Claudio Scriven back out at center ice. 8.5 to play in the first, and a 2-0 Kansas City lead. Masiccio, quick pass for Schuchuk. Gives to Mark Gregg across the line. Gregg trying to center, but he centered it right to Scriven, and the Blades turn it around. The City quite well. Moves it over to Donywood. It's bounced into the arrow, and that is offsides, and play is whistled down. The Blades lead it 2-0, 8:10 to go in the first. We'll be back. Blades with a 2-0 lead here in the Summit, 8:10 to go in the first period. Whether you need to entertain clients, reward employees, or just want a few nights out with friends and family, the Houston Arrows have a season ticket package for you. For more information, call 627-AERO. That's 627-ARO. Houston Arrows Hockey. Sports the way it ought to be. Face off at center ice. Bill Bowler against Dale Craigwell. Shot 7-6, and of those 6 shots that the Arrows have, I'd say 5 of them have been pretty good scoring chances, and I think that bodes well if they can keep plugging away as a shot handcuffing Chabot a little bit, had the blocker and was able to hold on to that. And play is stopped with 8:01 to go in the first.
Well, I believe the very good scoring chances are fairly even. but the Arrows have not scored, and obviously Kansas City has two by Frederick Chabot. One thing Dave Tippett believes in Frederick Chabot, if he doesn't get off to the start that Frederick Chabot likes to get off to, he battles in there.
Mike Hurlbutt in his own end, tied up by Brian Culleton. Here's Craigwell trying to knock it away from Bill Bowler. Culleton, or make that Craigwell back to the line. We've got a whistle, and I think we're going to have a couple of penalties here. We've got an interference minor as the first indication. I think this is coming to the Blades. It might be the only penalty. It's going to be an obstruction interference call. And is it Pat Furschweiler? It is.
Furschweiler getting a little interference call there. Obstruction getting in the way. You couldn't believe that. What a great job miking up the Summit here. We could hear that all the way up here, Adam, the obstruction call. What happens here is that he runs a little pick play, and you cannot run pick plays in hockey, and it's called obstruction, and he obstructs on Bill Bowler. Very good job by the cameraman to pick that up. That's 2 minutes. You cannot use pick plays in hockey.
That's right.
Here is Jim Kite back in his own end. He shoots it right out of place. That'll keep a faceoff in the Kansas City zone. So that's actually a bit of a break for the Arrows to start really their first full power play. They're 0 for 1 on the man advantage, but they only had 49 seconds with which to work on their previous power play. Their power play dipped down to 8th down the IHL at 17.6%, but you might recall that power play, it had the one chance in against Phoenix on Sunday and how terrific it looked, and it only took 7 seconds for him to score.
And how much would Dave Tippett like to see that power play go for 100% again as they did against the Roadrunners? So what, they only had one chance, Adam? They went 100%. Be nice to see them go 100% again.
Face off left side of Drouville. The ever optimistic Troy Gamble. I think everybody would agree with you. Puck is along the boards, dug out by the Arrows. Kuchera knocked it back to the line, held in by Tkachuk. Quick pass down along the boards, intercepted by Knight, trying to clear it. He reversed it down low, and it's jumped on by Norman Rochefort, and he cleared it the length of the ice. It'll bounce back and hit Craigwell. That's a two-line pass, and that'll bring a faceoff back into the Kansas City zone.
Jimmy Kite in 12 games, no points, 35 PMs, but he's the only legally deaf player to play hockey. He's legally deaf, and hockey is a game of communication. How tough has it been for him? And he's played 598 NHL games to communicate.
But when you're as smart as Jim Kite, it's not as important to communicate. This guy is so smart, he can read plays. You don't have to communicate. He sees the ice so well, and he knows what guys are doing. And plus, you know, this game is, I think, 90% read and react anyway.
And he does that very well.
Off the draw, Arrows have it, but it's intercepted by Craigwell and shot right back down the ice. The Arrows have a minute and a half to go on their power play, trailing 2-0.
And it doesn't hurt when you're 6'5", 220 pounds, as Jim Kite is.
He is intimidating. It is Tkachuk. He'll slide a pass out at center for Conroy. Hits the line. Conroy over to Kuchera. Shooting. Drouville stopped it. Rebound. As Conroy took a poke at it. Hurlbutt back to the point. Steers it down low. It's to Tkachuk. Gary Tkachuk on the power play. He's got a buck five to go. The drive by Hurlbutt. Right on. And a save made by Drouville. And he'll hold on as Mike Hurlbutt, with his two goals, trying to make it three. And he let a howitzer go from the top of the slot.
Very good shot by Mike Hurl, but the Arrows would like to have a little bit more traffic in front, but the Blade steer really clearing the front of the net. Al Conroy is going to end up getting a rebound here on Kuchera's shot. He tries to sneak it in for his first of the year. He just can't get wood on it as Jim Kite was all over the back of Al Conroy. One-timer here from the point from Gary Tkachuk. Mike Hurlbutt blasts it into the belly of Drouville.
Face-off right side of Drouville. Bill Bowler, Mark Craig, and Mark Lamb with Darcy Werwank and Dave Basigio.
Well, you can see how the defense for the Blades really cleared the front of the net there. Mike Hurlbutt, it's going to be tough to score from that blue line.
Werwanka has it at a left point, cuts in with a shot, it rolls up on him to the corner. It's Gary Emmett. Bumped by Lamb, but it's picked up by the Kansas City Blades, Norman Rochefort, and he'll get it up ice. Craig takes it away. Arrows trail 2-0. Looking to get on the board here and maybe give them a little momentum, get back into this thing. 6.5 to go in the first. Basigio threw it off the skates of Gary Emmons, and it's back to Dave Basigio at his own blue line. Arrows having a little trouble breaking it up ice right now. Basigio He'll hit the line, dump the puck in hard along the boards. DeRouville came in, poked it to the corner, dug out by Mark Gregg. Arrow's able to set up Gregg, and it fished out, though, by Sylvester. Can't clear. Gregg knocked it down. Here's Mark Gregg scampering down the left side. He centered it, but it was pushed away by Stremmen, and Dean Sylvester gets it ahead and out at center ice. Power play down to 7 seconds, and looks like that'll just about do it as the Arrow's tied up at center. Rowenka. High in the air, dumps the puck in, penalty over, teams at equal strength. Claudio Stremmen back in his own zone, pass for Gary Emmons, moves out at center ice with Furschweiler. Emmons hits the line, Emmons cutting to the right, gives to Furschweiler, trying to move in, and Chabot will steer it aside. Darcy Wawrinka, he'll move to center. Wawrinka's pass, missed freer, but it goes down to DeRouville. DeRouville will then foul on it, take no chances, he'll hold on with 5:28 to go in the first period, and the Blades leading by a score of 2-0.
DeRouville, seeing that Mark Freer was coming in wisely, decides to cover it up. Mark Freer with 10 points on the year. He's playing very well defensively. He's not getting the scoring chances that he wants, but he's not giving up and at the back on his net. He's very particular about playing well defensively right now. He believes if he plays very good defense, his offense will turn around, and then maybe he'll start being a little more creative and getting better chances.
While Mark Freer is still 3 points shy of 500 in his career, and three assists shy of 300. Almay to the corner, looped away by Jim Kite. Give it to Norman Rochefort, and it shot the length of the ice, but it went off an Arrow skate, so no icing had it even cross the line. Kuchera is hammered by John Purvis, and it's out at center for Rochefort. Puck is picked up by Purvis, and now it is Al May who gets it back. May fired it off of John Purvis. Here come the Kansas City Blades. Doty Wood knocked away by Jakes, and Jakes moves it up. Steve Jakes trying to feed one ahead. Here is Rob Valasevic across the line. Let's a shot go. Stuck aside by DeRouville, and he will hold on. Let's take timeout. 4:47 to go. First period in the Blades with a 2-0 lead. As the Blades lead it 2-0.
And Don Jackson, head coach of the Blades, who won a couple of Stanley Cups in Edmonton, really didn't have too many Europeans on his teams back then. I believe they only had one in Tikkanen. So he comes to Kansas City, who had 7 foreign players, Europeans, on their team last year. How many this year? 21 Canadian hockey players, 1 lone American.
Face off right side of Philip DeRouville. Tkachuk, Yo, and Al Conroy with Hurlbutt and Basigio. Puck goes to the corner. It's jumped on by Brian Stacey, cleared but not out. We're going to have a penalty, I think. I don't know. Our referee tonight is Jeff Smith, the linesman, Frank Prestia, Jim Annie, and Bob Williams. And the Arrows are going to get a penalty. Al Conroy in the box for elbowing.
Al Conroy getting his elbow up a little bit high. Jeff Smith was right there and said, oh, that's going to be 2 minutes. Al doesn't like the call. He just gets his glove up here. It's the second one, though, that he gets called on. The first time he brought up his left arm, Smith was not going to call it. It was the second time that Smith said, well, that's enough. You're going to go in the box for 2 minutes.
So the Arrows bring out Dave Basigio and Mike Hurlbutt defensively. Mike Yeo, and right now it looks like Gary Tkachuk will be the two penalty killers up front, as Dave Tippett giving some last second instructions to Gary Tkachuk, and I think he wants Gary Tkachuk to talk to Jeff Smith about something. You know, we do a pretty good job of miking Dauber. I wish we could mic the referee and hear sometimes the conversations that go on there.
I've seen it once before during an All-Star game. I think it might have been in the American Hockey League. They ref the official. It was very interesting, the conversation that some players have with the officials on the ice.
Off the faceoff, the Blades have got it, and here's Claudio Stremmen. So 2 minutes up on the board to Al Conroy, and the Blades turn it around. Cerrone to center for Purvis, and it goes into the Arrow end. In after it, Doty Wood. Wood to the corner, looking along the boards. He'll set up on the power play. It's the second of the night. It's a shot by Stremmen, slammed wide to the net. Puck centered, here's Purvis, shot, score! What a goal from John Purvis! Wow, in the slot, over the glove hand of Freddie Shabbat. It's a power play goal, and the Blades lead it 3-0.
The Blades have been waiting for John Purvis to break out with only 3 goals so far this year, all created from a very good pass into the slot. Purvis just fires the puck. Frederick Shabbat could have been screened a little bit from Mike Hurl, but not quite sure. All started from a good pass, but the release of John Purvis is so quick, and he knows where he wants to go with that puck, and that's upstairs over Frederick Shabbat's glove. They've been waiting for Purvis to break out, Adam. We talked to Doug Sotart before the game. He really couldn't understand why he only has 3 goals on the season. Well, now with 1 tonight, that's 4. He could be on his way.
Faceoff is controlled by Claudio Schremmen. He'll shoot the puck into the arrow end. Back goes Steve Jakes. Jakes will roll it to Guy LaRose, and he'll break it out at center ice. Now Lamb gives chase. Lamb down the left side, jammed to the corner. Schremmen lost it. Here's Lamb cutting right in. Deeks, Wade shoots, stopped by DeRouville. Centered again, but the Blades have it. And it's cleared out at center ice. Dean Sylvester trying to move it ahead. That's knocked away. The arrows have to go back. Here's David Bruce moving in. Shot is blocked, deflected to the corner for Sylvester. Trying to jam it to the corner. Now it is Sylvester tied up by Jakes. Good battle into the corner as Sylvester trying to skate away from Jakes, and the arrows have got it. No, it was turned over nearly by Kucera. His pass was knocked away, and now the arrows bring it up. Guy LaRose giving chase to Rouville out of the net. Now Mark Lamb worked it down for Mark Craig. Trying to send it along the boards for Dave Basigio. Basigio hooked it down for Lamb. He's hammered by Rochefort along the boards. In there's Mark Craig trying to loosen it up. Craig waiting, but he centered it right to Dean Sylvester, and the Blades will come out with it. Sylvester out at center, shoots the puck into the arrowhead. Rowenka going back, and Basigio turns it around. His pass worked away by Rochefort. We're under two, and we're at 2:40 to play in this first period. 3-0 Kansas City. Schremmen trying to hold. It came back to center. Blades will regroup. Paul Dick sides it ahead, but Darcy Rowenka is there. Good pass for Bowler, too far. Arrows bring it in. Here's Bowler, right side, cutting right in on goal. Deeks, Wade shoots. Stopped by DeRuga, and he will hold on. 2:20 to go in the first. 3-0 Kansas City.
Bill Bowler just ran out of a little bit of real estate. He ended up being behind the net. He tried to sweep it back in, but DeRuville was there to pounce on the puck. Very good play by Bill Bowler. He waited, he was patient. Good play by Dave Morissette to drive to the net. Bill Bowler just runs out of room. Puck jumps off his stick. DeRuville jumps on the loose puck. Billy Bowler was trying to go around and then come back in. There's just no room, no real estate left to go. Once that puck jumped off his stick, he didn't have a chance.
Face off left side of DeRuville. Bowler with Morissette, May, Basigio, and Rowenka. Al May along the boards, and we've got a whistle, and we've got another penalty. We've got Bowler getting jumped on by Cerrone. Is that Bowler? No. Was that Bowler that picked him up? Bowler picked up Cerrone, which is not the easiest thing to do, and threw him down.
He leg whipped him and got on top of him. I don't know what transpired before that. Cerrone and Bill Bowler were jostling. Bill Bowler said, I had enough of that, I'm gonna get on top.
Well, the arrows right now trying to find something to get their fire lit, because they trailed this thing 3-0 on three pretty good goals. More importantly, that Purvis goal was unbelievable, though.
Well, that's why last year he scored 54 goals in this league, second to only Craig Fisher. Once we see that back on replay, hopefully in the first period, watch the quick release that Purvis has. He snaps that puck so quick. It's very tough for any goaltender to stop that puck, especially when it's up top shelf.
Jeff Smith, the referee, I think had an original penalty before all that started. He may get an instigator with Cerrone.
I believe that the arrows will come out on top and likely have a 2-minute power play, but who knows?
Watch the replay. For those of you watching on Fox Sports, I think Bowler got him pretty good on the faceoff with a slash, and that's where the penalty is. Oh, yeah. That might be what the original penalty is to Bill Bowler.
What a great replay. I never caught that slash. The puck went back to the point. Bill Bowler trying to get a little extra room by slashing off. I think Cerrone might get an extra two for starting the roughhousing, so it might end up even.
While we've got a minute, let's remind you that when you watch the Houston Aeros on Fox Sports, you could win a trip for two on Southwest Airlines for a sportsman vacation. You'll look like a pro with a $500 Academy gift certificate, and you can enjoy a $500 Ace Travel House certificate for ground transportation. Just watch the game and listen for your cue to call in and win a sportsman vacation from Southwest Airlines.
That's a new fucking rule.
And those prizes, as we talked before, Adam, are the best in the IHL. What a great trip. Ace Travel House, $500 gift certificate, Academy. You can buy all the sportswear you need.
Well, let's hear the calls. Let's see if we can pick them up.
2 minutes for slashing, 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct, and 5 minutes for fighting.
They missed the little slash from Bill Bowler.
Well, he likely just, maybe the referee thought it was just a tap to push off. Next thing you know, Cerrone's going to be in the box for 4 minutes. If the Arrows ever needed a spark, this would be it, because you look now, they're on the power play for 2 minutes, and then after that, they're going to get a fresh sheet of ice for another 2 minutes. They could whittle down this lead, hopefully by one, and then come back out and have 2 minutes of fresh ice. Huge break for the Arrows. This could be a turning point for this Arrow team tonight.
Well, they've been looking for a break. I think the Blades are, you know, complaining, and rightfully so, about the no slashing call.
And the one thing that the Arrows are going to have to contend with on this power play, as I said before, the last six games they killed off 19. Well, that's 21 now, as the Arrows have already been on a couple power plays. The Blades have been very, very good. Well, they've been the best the last six games. No one's been able to score on them.
All right, so the Arrows now are going to get their chance at a double minor power play. If you're the Arrows, though, I would watch yourself very carefully, because makeup call could be in the making.
Well, you just have to make sure that if you're holding on to a player with your stick or your hand, you have to keep your feet moving, because if that guy goes down, they're going to call you for interference or hooking.
All right, Tkachuk, Conroy, LaRose with Hurlbut and Kuchera. The Arrows will get half the 4 minute minor here and the other half in the second. What a chance for the Arrows to crawl right back into this thing.
And I said that the Arrows would love to get one. Well, I should say that they would love to get two in this first 2 minutes. But if they don't, they still have that clean sheet of ice for the last minute and 45.
All right, we're ready to go. Tkachuk to take the faceoff against Cragwell. Off the faceoff, the Blades have got it. Jim Kite swings it along, and it's all the way down the ice.
And that's what Jim Kite, simple player, when he gets that chance to ice the puck, 9 out of 10 times, he gets it high up on the glass and gets it all the way down.
Gary Tkachuk will skate out at center ice for Houston. Quick pass, too far for Kuchera. It's picked up by Rochefort, and he'll clear it himself. And Hurlbut couldn't hold it in. They'll call it offside. It's good effort by Hurlbut, but he couldn't hold it in. You know, you're talking about two veteran defensemen and Jim Kite and Norman Rochefort back on the blue line, and I don't think you're going to find any two smarter, better defensemen anywhere.
Well, they both have so much experience. What happens there, though, with Mike Hurlbut, is he jumps up to get the puck, but Boyce and Cragwell are all over him. They're on top of Mike Hurlbut. Mike Hurlbut tries to keep it in, but with the constant pressure of the Blades, he cannot do it.
Tkachuk against Gary Emmons at center. Tkachuk wins the draw. Picked up by Kuchera and across the line. Kuchera trying to center when it came down, and Deruva will cover it up and hold on, but that'll keep the faceoff in the Kansas City zone. With a buck 42 to go in the first period, 3-0 Kansas City, 3:27 left. And the double minor to Jason Cerrone.
Drewville's played very well so far early in this game. He has two shutouts this year. He's one of those Pittsburgh draft choices. He's on loan from Pittsburgh. And as you say, Larry Dick has not been able to play that much. He's played the last seven in a row. Drewville has.
Face off left side of Drewville. Tkachuk against Emmons. Arrows win it. Here's Kuchera, tees it up, shoots, stopped by DeRuvel, and he will hold on to it. So the Arrows winning the draw, and Kuchera able to get the shot onto Philip DeRuvel. Be sure to stay with us in the first intermission. We'll have an update from the clubhouse, and for those of you listening on KKHT, we'll have a news update for you. We'll have highlights from the first period and a look at the Arrows community calendar, all in the first intermission, so please stay with us.
And I'm sure Dave Tippett's saying, I'd love the Arrows to get a highlight in that first period, hopefully a goal.
Face off left side of DeRuvel. Yeah, right now the highlights might be a little lopsided. See if the Arrows with a minute 38 can get one. Here's Kuchera, the shot. Blockered away by DeRuvel. Jumped on by Hurlbutt. Hurlbutt rolled it down in behind the net. Here is Guy LaRose. LaRose on the power play, waiting, sends one over, threw it into the skates of Kuchera. And here is Gary Emmons. He'll bring it across the line. Shot right on, and a pad save made by Shabbat. Hurlbutt moving ahead for Shuchuk. Shuchuk out at center. Here's Mark Gregg across the line. He centered one, but it was a floater that LaRose couldn't get to. Now Kuchera trying to center out of the reach of LaRose. LaRose turning on the power play with a minute two in the period. Here's Shuchuk shooting, stopped by DeRuvel. Kuchera gives to LaRose, back to Kuchera. Rolled it over to Guy LaRose, getting set on the power play. Here's Kuchera, winding, shooting, stuck aside by DeRuvel. It's picked up by Skremen, and he'll skate it up and shoot it down the ice.
Arrows getting a lot of shots from the point, but they're not getting that constant pressure in front of DeRuvel. He's seeing mostly all the shots from the point.
Mark Lamb, get it out at center for Freer. Here comes Basigio, and he'll drill one in. In after it, it's Mark Gregg. Sends it quickly back to Wawrinka at the point. Darcy Wawrinka over to Gregg. 23 to go in the period. Here is a pass. Gregg right in, shooting to DeRuvel. A great glove save, and he'll hold on. What a play between Mark Lamb and Mark Gregg as the Marx brothers back out there, but they couldn't tally a mark, and it's still 3-0.
Mark Freer gets the one-touch pass. It's a give-and-go pass. Mark Freer feeds it right back. Boom, what a shot by Mark Freer. Mark Lamb feeds it tape to tape. Mark Freer tries to snap it. He'd like to get it up a little higher. Pressure forces him to shoot it not as high as he wants.
I knew it was a Mark, not Gregg. It was Mark Freer.
Well, how tough is it with three of them on the ice at one time? The Marky Mark line, as we called it earlier in the season.
Face off left side of DeRuvel. Lamb, Freer, and Gregg stay out there.
Maybe that's the way to call it.
Well, if I say Mark has the puck, I can't go wrong, unless Basigio gets it. And the puck is shot through Basigio and back down the ice. That'll just about do it for the period. Maybe enough for a quick rush. Wawrinka gives it to Mark Lamb. 5 seconds to go in the period. Freer across the line with Gregg. That's knocked away, and that should be the period as the buzzer sounds, ending period number one. Well, not the greatest of periods for the Houston Arrows as they trail 3-0 after 20 minutes of action. Going to be interesting to see what Dave Tippett has to say to his troops in this intermission.
Well, I'm sure he has mixed emotions about the period, that at times they played well. They had some good chances. They didn't score. When the Blades had chances to score, they buried the puck past Frederick Shabbat.
3-0, the Blades lead it, and we'll have more from the Summit after this timeout and a report from the clubhouse. We'll be back. Kansas City Blades with a 3-0 lead in the first intermission from the Summit. Welcome back, Adam Gordon, Troy Gamble. And well, you know, I'm sure Dave Tippett found some problems with his defensive zone coverage, but I think first and foremost, they got to find a way to settle down Frederick Shabbat. Just not a classic Shabbat-like outing in that opening frame.
Well, it's not the way Frederick Shabbat certainly played last game. The one thing, he just didn't seem as confident in the net, but Dave Tippett has so much confidence in Frederick Shabbat that he believes that he can battle through any type of adversity. This is a little adversity for Frederick Shabbat.
Yeah, I don't think Tippett's the only one that's got confidence. I think everyone in that locker room's got a lot of confidence with Freddie Shabbat, but it's going to be up to him to kind of battle himself and get himself back into this hockey game. And I think if the Arrows can whittle away at that lead, they're obviously going to be back in this thing.
Well, they have to whittle away, but the one thing, Adam, that I noticed is that defensive zone coverage and passing, two things in the Gamble game plan, they were not on that period, and that defensive zone coverage hurt.
Rob Dobson made the point in the when we went down to him, he said, you know, the Arrows got one shot, but when you look at the highlights, it was a turnover that resulted in the first goal for Jason Cerrone.
Those turnovers are going to kill you, Adam.
Cerrone ends up lasting the puck here. It was a turnover at the blue line in the gray area. Lasted far side on Frederick Chabot. Off the post, a very good shot, but still, if Frederick Chabot's on, he makes that save.
Cerrone, his fifth of the year at 2:16. It was an unassisted goal, and the Blades led it 1-0, but they would make it 2-0 as Doty Wood was left all alone down the right side.
Well, he just had so much time. He ends up picking five hole on Frederick Chabot. I don't know if that was the scouting report from them or what, but he was going five hole all the way.
Yeah, there was no question. Chabot never came up with it. Wood is second of the year at 7:52 from Craigwell and Scremmen. But definitely the goal of the night belongs to John Purvis on the power play.
What a shot. That quick release, top shelf, off the top post, in by a surprise Frederick Chabot. John Purvis has the capability of making those shots.
Power play goal is fourth of the year for John Purvis at 15:46. Brian Stacey and Claudio Scremmen getting the assist. 3-0 Kansas City, but they also did get a little help from Philip Drouville.
Well, he played so well all period. He made some very good saves here. He makes a good glove save on Mark Freer, who got a great pass from Mark Lamb, who was in the corner. And Drouville was up to the task once again here. Back from the point, Mike Curl, but last the shot, traffic in front, off a leg of a Kansas City Blades. Then Mark Freer just could not find the handle. He was behind the net. That puck is a few inches in front of Mark Freer. He puts that in the net.
Arrows have around 2 minutes to work on the power play to start the second period, so a little bit of a bonus on fresh ice to work with. They get a goal on that power play, and there's lots of hockey to go.
Well, there is a lot of hockey, and the one thing that this Arrow team has is that character, and I believe they'll come out, they'll try to establish that point shot once again, but once they establish that point shot, they want traffic in front of the net. Look for some bodies bashing in front of Drouville.
I'm sure Dave Tippett will have his troops flying when we resume play in the second period. Our score from the Summit, it's the Kansas City Blades 3 and the Houston Arrows no score. We'll have stats after this. Blades with a 3-0 lead after 20 minutes of play from the Summit. And it is time to take a look at tonight's first period stats. They're brought to you by your local Texas Chrysler Plymouth dealers. Shots 18-10 in that first period in favor of the Houston Arrows. Power plays, Kansas City 1 of 2 on the power play. And the Arrows 0 for 3, but they do have 2 minutes remaining on their fourth power play. Look at the power play shots, 8-1 in favor of the Houston Arrows. Penalty minutes 13 for Kansas City, 11 for Houston. And the faceoff 16-15 in favor of the Kansas City Blades. It is 3-0. Kansas City leads it. And when Troy Gamble and I return, we'll have the second period of action. We'll be back after this. We are moments away from starting period number two. The Blades leading the Houston Arrows by a score of 3-0. And it's time to take a look at the Arrows community calendar brought to you by Columbia Healthcare Centers. Healthcare has never worked quite like this. December 6th is a very busy day. It's group ticket faith night. You can enjoy a post-game rally featuring the Arrows' Steve Jakes and Graham Townsend. You can hear them speak about the role of faith in their lives. Call 627 Arrow for your group tickets. Also, it's the second annual Houston Arrow Wives Toy Drive. You can bring a toy to the game and receive two $10 tickets for the price of one. All proceeds benefit the Texas Children's Hospital. Well, Troy, the Arrows, who have been trying to find a way to lighten things up, have come up with a new award. It's called the Antler Award, and it's named after Moose Morissette, who is the first recipient of the Antler Award. What a fine piece of hardware that is.
Well, look at that piece of hardware, and what it is, it goes to the player that the players believe did the best job that night. Moose will be able to award this tonight. And whoever gets it, look at the perks that you get out of this award.
Don Pardo, tell us what they win.
You win the first parking space out at the Aerodrome, right by the door. Music in the dressing room, whatever type of music you want to listen to, you can listen to it. And the best of all is that you can tell anyone to fetch you a Coke, a coffee. You're the boss for
the day.
Yeah,
by the way, Troy, where's my Coke?
Hey, I don't see you with the award on your head.
Oh.
I just see you with a headset, not an award yet.
It is an award that the Moose Morissette got named after him after his effort the last game. It's a lot like winning a game ball, getting a game ball in football. Right now, the Arrows trailing 3-0. Would love to find a hero step up and earn the award now. Here's Basigio, the shot block. It came back along the boards. Arrows with a minute and a half to work on the power play. Roenka, top of the slot, slides it down for Freer. Mark Freer getting set along the boards, worked it back to the line. Roenka shot blocked by Ian Boyce, and that'll go down the ice.
Ian Boyce sliding out, Darcy Wawrinka blocking the shot. He felt that one. He went off very slow.
Wawrinka forechecked by Cody Wood, and Basicio will play it.
Right here, Woody, right here.
Wawrinka pass ahead, and it's brought in by Mark Gregg. Tipped away by Jim Kiten. It's out at center ice, and Wawrinka will play it. Here's Mark Freer across the line. Freer getting set on the power play, gives to Wawrinka. The shot deflected by Wood. He batted that out of midair and out at center ice. That's a great play by Doty Wood. Wawrinka. He'll move it up ice for LaRose. Guy LaRose trying to turn. That's poked away, but Lamb chased it down along the boards. And he'll rip one right off the side and into Kansas City territory. DeRouville swings it right over to Conroy. Power play down to half a minute. Gary Shuchuk sets up right wing boards. Back to the line, Kuchera. Gives it over to Shuchuk. Arrows down to 20 on the power play. Kuchera tees it up, shoots right on, and DeRouville makes the save.
DeRouville on the top of his goalie crease again. Frank Kuchera blasting the shot. No one in front, so DeRouville wisely gathers it in his midsection, covers it up. Look at Adam Sandler there.
He does look like Adam Sandler.
He certainly does. Gary Shuchuk gets it over here to Kuchera. Kuchera just wants to put it on the net, hoping for a tip. Well, there was the tip. But DeRouville on top of that crease, tipped right into the breadbasket. Good play by the Arrows to get that good shot and the little tip from the top of the hash marks.
Face off right side of Philip DeRouville. Arrows have it. Hurlbut a shot whistled wide. Picked up Conroy. Getting set on the mat. Advantage. Down to 10 on the power play. Conroy worked it back to Hurlbut. Got some room. He'll steer it over to Al Conroy. Arrows trying to get into this thing. Down 3-0. Shoot shot. Slides it back. Hurlbut one-time shot. Broke his stick. Had a tough break. It's a 3-on-1. And now a breakaway. Culleton's in alone. Shoots. Chabot with the save. He made a great save. And the puck is turned around. I don't think the doctor could order anything better for Frédéric Chabot. Here's Culleton right in. Centered. That's tipped away. Sylvester. He lets his shot go. Held in. Scremmen. Slides it for Evans. Centered. Here's the centering pass again. Knocked away. And the Arrows are out with it. Conroy out at center. He'll shoot the puck into the Kansas City zone. Back goes Scremmen. In behind the net. He'll wind it up ice. The pass. Brought out to neutral ice for Sylvester. He'll hit the line as he dumped it in. What a big save a moment ago by Frédéric Chabot on Ryan Culleton. Passes out at center. It in and the puck goes up and out of play. 17:22 to go in the second period. 3-0 Kansas City. Let's go down to Rob Dobson and Dobber. A moment ago, Freddie Chabot with a big save. That's got to give him his confidence.
Yeah, I think so, Adam. You know, the first period there was a couple goals, and as I mentioned, in a first of a game, you want to get a pretty easy shot. And you know, Cerrone's shot was a tough one, but I think he's battled back strong. And you get a save like that early in the second, and your confidence grows. You know, unfortunately, his early stick breaks there, or you know, we get a pretty good chance. But that's good for the confidence. And unfortunately, we didn't score, but we just have to take this in little steps and get right back in our hockey game.
Did Dave Tippett show his true colors, just keep things positive in the locker room?
I'm sorry?
Did Dave Tippett show his true colors and keep things positive in the locker room?
He tried. You know, unfortunately, we've got away from our game plan and have to get back and get stronger. We didn't do the little things, and you know, a coach can only stay positive so long without getting a little upset.
All right, thanks a lot, Connor. Icing the call on the Houston Arrows and a faceoff.
Come on, boys, come on,
boys. Down into the Arrows end.
Dauber, you can hear him being positive on the bench after we went away there. Very positive guy, Rob Dobson, on the bench. He always keeps the guys up as much as he can, and Frédéric Chabot turned a bad, unfortunate play. Mike Hurlbut breaks his stick. Guy comes out of the box. Frédéric Chabot showing his true colors, standing tall in the net.
Face off right side of Frédéric Chabot. The Arrows looking to climb back from a 3-0 deficit. Off the faceoff, the Arrows give chase. Here's Jakes behind the net. He'll send one along, and Mike Yeo moves it up and out. Mike Yeo, a cross-ice pass picked up by Conroy. Conroy dropped it for Shuchuk. Quick shot stuck aside by DeRouville. Now it is Shanks moving down the boards. Looks in front. Here's Yeo. Quick shot stopped by DeRouville. Bang away at it. DeRouville down. And right there, I think, is what the Arrows are looking for a little bit more of, crashing the net. It's 3-0. The Blades lead it, and we'll have more when we return. But first, this word from Southwest Airlines. Kansas City leads it 3-0, but a moment ago, Troy, the Arrows nearly dented the scoreboard.
Well, Mike Yode puts the puck on the net. Gary Tkachuk winning a battle in front of the net. Whacks at it. But big Jim Kite was also up to the task. That's a very good one-on-one battle. Steve Jakes making a very good play to Mike Yode. Mike Yode firing the puck, turning around very quickly. Gary Tkachuk battling. That's what Dave Tippett loves to see, is those battles in front of the net.
Face off, left side. Philip DeRouville, Tkachuk with Conroy and Yo, Basigio and Jakes defensively. Puck is won back to the point, held in by Basigio, scooped it down for Al Conroy. Now after Claudio Stremmen, he'll gather in the puck, hammered by Yo in the corner. It came out in front, but Stremmen was there, and it's pushed out at center. 3.5 gone in the second. Blaze lead it 3-0. Steve Jakes back at his own blue line. Give it over to Basigio, and he'll move it up ice. The pass onto the tape of Yo. Mike Yo had it tipped away by Sylvester, and Jakes will go back for it.
You can see that the Blades are not forechecking as hard since they have that 3-0 lead. They're being a little more passive.
Here's David Bruce down the right side, centered for Emmons, blocked by Basigio. Nice defensive play there. And it's cleared, but not out. Second effort cleared by Tkachuk, and Conroy's got a lane. Conroy trying to move it down, the pass through the skates of Basigio. Basigio sets up along the right wing boards, waiting, turns it back, but it's intercepted by the Blades, and we've got a whistle and a penalty coming up to Kansas City. Yo got clipped from behind the play, and I think the Arrows are going to get a power play here. High sticking the call.
Mike Yo taking that high stick in the face area.
Pull out the puck.
Jeff Smith wisely makes the quick call. Mike Yo going over to say, hey, I'm cut a little bit. David Bruce is going to go for high sticking. Only 2 minutes. There's one of those calls that maybe you get 4 minutes. I can't see how bad Mike Yo was cut, but he was wiping something away from his face area. David Bruce going, I didn't do it. Someone did it, Dave, but maybe it wasn't you. Mike Yo got a high stick in the face area.
2 minutes up on the board to Bruce as the Arrows will get another crack on the power play. They've had unofficially 8 shots on goal on the power play, and see if they can keep it going here and try and dent the twine. It is Bowler against Wood. Wood wins the draw and create it back out at center ice. It is Darcy Wawrinka back in his own end. He'll set up the power play from within his own zone to break it out. Bill Bowler, he'll wind it up, the pass for Hurlbutt. He'll bring to center, the pass through Lamb and into Kansas City territory. Lamb fights for it with Kite. Bowler trying to swing it along. In skates, Bowler fished it out. Bill Bowler, he'll turn it on the left wing. Pass back to the point. Arrows quickly move the puck around. Wawrinka. Waiting, still with the puck, sends it back to the line. Hurlbutt shooting, it's deflected away. Giving chase, it's Firstweiler. He'll move up with it and clear it out at center. Gives to Doty Wood, and it's shot right back down into the Arrow end. 1:15 left for the Bruce penalty, 5 minutes gone in the second period, 3-0 Kansas City. Pass out at center for Mark Rigg, that is knocked away. And shot back into the Arrow end. It's Darcy Wawrinka. He'll break out with it. Wawrinka, nice bit of stick handling in his own zone. Goes to Hurlbutt, and he'll shoot it in. Giving chase is Mark Gray. Pushed away by Rochefort. They battle in the corner. Now the Arrows dig it out. Bill Bowler swings it back to the line for Wawrinka. Gives to Mark Lamb. Lamb quarterbacking the power play from the half court. Sends it back down for Bowler. 35 to go on the power play. Mark Lamb, give and go with Bowler. Instead it comes back, Wawrinka, one-time shot, stopped by DeRouville, and the rebound slides behind Mark Gregg, and the puck goes down the ice.
Again, a point shot by the Arrows, just no one there to get the rebound or cause a lot of traffic.
Arrows have it, Conroy, out at center. Bill Bowler turns it around, it goes back down in behind Frederick Chabot. Conroy is there with 5 seconds remaining on the power play. Here's a turn. Score! 4-0 Kansas City, a shorthanded goal on another Arrow turnover in their own end, and the Blades take a 4-0 lead.
Emmon gets a gift on his stick, ends up going in all alone on Frederick Chabot. beating him five hole. Al Conroy was trying to make a pass to one of the defense. The defense did not see it coming. It was a little bit, well, it was behind him. Emmons jumps on the loose puck, ends up going five hole. That's two times tonight. The Blades have went five hole on Frederick Chabot. Al Conroy just trying to make the pass to Wierenka. Wierenka was a little bit in front of him. Emmons does not miss that glorious chance.
It's 4-0 Kansas City. Mike Hill brings it back, and it slid along the boards. Al May had it knocked away. Here is Purvis, that's knocked away. Mike Hill in the corner, tied up by Screven. And it's John Purvis, cleared over to Alan May, and it's right back out at center ice. Well, mistakes have hurt the Arrows tonight, thus far. Here is Purvis. He'll shoot the puck in.
It's been the mistakes of the big nature that have let the Blades get great opportunities. And they buried those opportunities.
Here is Steve Jakes. He'll send a pass up for Mike Yeo. Yeo across the line, centered. Al May, the shot stopped by DeRuville. And the Blades batted up and out of play. With exactly 13 minutes to go in the second period. Timeout on the ice, 4-0 Kansas City. A 4-0 Kansas City lead with exactly 13 minutes to go, and this Summit building's gonna be busy for the next couple days.
Well, last night the Lakers were in town, and what a game that was. I watched that game at home. The basketball court was on the ice last night. They just put a chipboard down on the ice. They just throw the basketball court onto the ice. They take out all the glass naturally. Hockey game tonight, basketball court goes on after the game. Basketball game, they lift it up for Friday. The Arrows play, take it down again. Basketball game Saturday. A lot of work by the Summit crew, and they do a great job.
I'm amazed at how you know that, which leads me to believe maybe in your off time you work for the Summit crew.
Well, I like to sneak in and watch the basketball games every once in a while.
Oh, is that what it is? Oh, I'm sure the Rockets are pleased to hear that. Doty Wood. He'll move it out at center ice. Knocked away by Kuchera. And here is Gary Tkachuk across the line with Valasemic. Tkachuk cutting in center. DeRuville knocked that away. Conroy gathers it back in to the point. Hurl butt shot deflected away. Kicked loose by Paul Dick. In after it. Mark Freer behind the net. Waiting, trying to center. Now Conroy, quick shot in the glove. Save made by DeRuville, and he'll hold on. 12 and a half to go in the second. 4-0 Kansas City.
And DeRuville had to make a good save, but if he was in his proper position, it wouldn't have been that big of a save. Al Conroy is going to get the puck in front of the net. He's going to shoot the puck. Good save by DeRuville, but if he just stands there, he makes that save. He makes it a little bigger than what it was. Mark Fuhrer trying to set up Al Conroy, then Al Conroy with that quick snapshot. DeRuville with the big glove, but makes it look a little bigger than what it really was. If he's just standing there, it would likely just hit him in the pads.
Tkachuk, Conroy, and Freer with Kuchera and Hurlbutt. And sticks are down between Emmons and Tkachuk, but a false start. And Bob Williams, the linesman, says, "You're out of here, Gary." So they'll bring in Al Conroy. Take on Gary Emmons. It's a pair of 15s. Duel in the circle. Drop of the puck. Conroy wins the draw. Back to Kuchera. Slides it along the board. Tkachuk's got it. Gary Tkachuk trying to toss it down for Al Conroy. Conroy into the corner. Looped it down. Here's a chance. Freer trying to stuff one in there. Freer, good job of stick handling in the corner. Mark Freer, pass back. Hurlbutt sends a hard pass down low into behind that. It's Rochefort that worked it away, but right to Al Conroy. Gives in front. Here's a quick shot. Score! Mark Freer! That puck changed direction on DeRuville, and the Arrows are on the board. It's a 4-1 Kansas City lead.
It went off Jim Pite's stick, but Mark Freer snapping that puck so quickly that it ends up going five hole on DeRuville. Very good shot by Mark Freer, but it ends up starting from a very good pass from Al Conroy. Al Conroy feathers a pass to Mark Freer, who one times it. Looks like it goes off the leg of Jim Pite, but Al Conroy very wisely gets the puck to Mark Freer, who snaps it one-timer through DeRuville's five hole.
off after it goes off a leg.
So now Mark Freer just 2 points shy of 500 in his pro career. Point number 498. Arrows down 4-1. Here comes Jakes again. Jakes shoots the puck in. It's icing unless Lamb can get there. Lamb on his horse. He will get there and negate the icing. Good work there. Finished down by Ian Boyce. And it's cleared out to center ice. Boyce rolled it into Arrow territory. Out of the net, Shabbat. Shabbat links it along the boards. Here is Firstweiler. Centered one to Boyce. It's in skates, but the Arrows come out with it. Guy LaRose in transition. 3-on-2. Dropped it for Lamb, though. And Lamb centered it. A one-time shot. Bandon. Here's another shot. Stopped in front. Picked up by Greg. Faked the shot, but he turned one over out at center ice. He tried to steer one for Jakes, but the Arrows have come back. They sense maybe a little bit of momentum. Back is Brian Stacey in the Kansas City zone. And he'll roll one along the boards to Culleton. It's out at center for Firstweiler. He'll crank one in, a long shot, high and wide to Shabbat. Kucera gives it over to Dave DiCiccio. And here comes Frank Kucera. Lead pass, missing everybody, and the Blades go back for it. Rochefort turns it around. A pass ahead for Jason Cerrone. Gives to Rochefort. Shooting. Bump save by Shabbat. And the Arrows are the other way. A lead pass. Poke check, though, by David Bruce. Cerrone gives to Bruce. He's in on goal. Shooting. Shabbat to save, and he'll hold on. 10:28 to go in the second period. 4-1, Kansas City.
And that's where Frederick Shabbat needs to be, on the top of that crease. David Bruce takes the shot from just inside the top of the circle. He had nowhere to shoot it. Frederick Shabbat dropping in that half butterfly, eats it up right into the crest of the Arrow on his jersey. He's on the top of the crease. When you're on the top of the crease, it's very tough for anyone to score. And that was when he was on the top of the crease with the glove. Big glove by Frederick Shabbat. And this one, I'd say that was right in the middle of the crest.
Like it. That's why they call him the targets. Puck is in the Arrow end. Houston trying to clear. Yo trying to bounce it out of there, and Hurlbutt will go back. Frank Kucera for Houston. He'll move out at center ice. Steered the puck ahead, knocked away by Bruce, kicked it in, and it rolls back deep into Arrow territory as Hurlbutt will play it. Mike Hurlbutt sends one off the boards, intercepted Purvis. John Purvis centered one. David Bruce gives chase, flipped one behind the net. Hurlbutt goes back. Puck battled in behind as Hurlbutt is there. They tie up along the boards, and it's kicked over for Gary Emmons. Emmons waiting, waiting, playing peekaboo. He centered one, and that's fished away by Alan May. Pass goes into the Kansas City zone. DeRouville will play it. And Jim Kite is back behind his net. Sends one along the boards. Picked away by Alan May. Kicked it down but cleared by Kansas City. Back out at center ice. Dave DiCiccio gives it up to Mark Freer, who's got the Arrow goal. Puck is dumped in, and there is Norman Rochefort to play it. Rochefort turning in his own zone. Nearly had it taken away by Freer, but Boyce comes out at center. Purvis dumped it in. In after it is Jakes. And Conroy misplaying it. Here come the Arrows. Gary Tkachuk. Tkachuk turns it center ice. He'll wind it up through the neutral zone. Dump the puck in. Out of the net, DeRouville. Tkachuk comes barreling in, trying to knock it away from Paul Dick. Puck swung along the boards and held in by DiCiccio. Quick pass down low for Tkachuk. He's tied up along the boards by Brian Stacey. They grind it out. Freer. Mark Freer in the circle. Cutting in. Centered. Conroy lets a shot go. Back goes wide. Freer turns one over to Conway. The shot right on, and a left pad save made by Philip DeRouville. Nice shot by Conroy as the puck goes back down. Shabbat hands one over to Jakes as the Arrows quickly turn it around. Steve Jakes lost the puck, turned it over. Here's Culleton, right side, right on goal. Here's the shot by Craigwell. Again, the Arrows with another turnover in their own end. Not really helping their case right now. Puck in front, the shot stopped by Shabbat, and he'll cover it up. And play is whistled down. We'll take a timeout. 8:13 to go in the second. The Blades with a 4-1 lead. Kansas City leading 4-1 with 8:13 to go in the second period. And I'm feeling benevolent again, Troy, so I guess it's time to give something away. How about it's time now to give you a chance to win a trip for two on Southwest Airlines. New number to call, though. Caller 10 at 713-789-1069. You can win a trip for two on Southwest Airlines for a sportsman vacation. 713-789-1069. Caller number 10. Off the faceoff, it's Firstweiler behind the net. He's tied up by Hurlbutt. They battle into the corner. Lamb takes his man to the wall. 8 minutes to go in the second period. Firstweiler rolled it along, and there's Guy LaRose. He'll gently clear it out at center ice as Rochefort hustles back. Rob Valasevic giving chase to Rochefort. He'll come out with a puck, though, and swing it out to center ice. Give it up to Firstweiler as he hits the line, looking for Craigwell, trying to cut in. Craigwell backhander off the skate of Kuchera. Picked up by Culliton. He's hammered by LaRose. Big hit by LaRose, and he takes the puck and shoots it in. Jim Kite going back. He's hit by Valasevic. Along the boards, though, Firstweiler's got it, and it'll be brought out at center ice. 7:25 to play in the second period. The Arrows trailing 4-1. Houston's Frank Kuchera gets to center ice for Guy LaRose. Late in the shift, though, he needs a line change. He'll dump the puck in, and he'll come off for the change. Ryan Stacey, pass intercepted by Masiccio, and it's brought in by Freer, but that is offsides, and play is whistled down. 7:07 to go in the second, and a 4-1 Blade lead.
We're going to look for the Arrows to make very good changes, very quick changes to keep fresh legs out there. Mark Freer showing that one-time shot for the goal, getting it off very, very quick. 16 games has those 10 points. The Arrows are moving their feet and skating a lot better. It's amazing what a goal does. Guy LaRose with a big hit, winning that battle, and taking the puck up ice. Those are the battles that you need to win if they're going to get back into this game.
Puck is in the Kansas City zone. Freer digging at it with John Purvis. Freer had it loosened up by Paul Dick, and he'll shoot it along the board. Picked away by Jenks. Lobbed it down for Tkachuk. Skip one in front. Conroy hammered by Cerrone, but he pops right back up, and the Arrows have it. Freer, right side, handed over to Jenks. Looks in front. Conroy in a battle, but the shot went wide of the net. Here's Masiccio. He'll wind one along. Arrows cycling the puck pretty good here as they'll just roll it along the boards. Conroy, tied up by Doty Wood. It came out in front, but it's poked away by the Blade defense, and they're out at center ice. John Purvis across the line. Purvis gives to Cerrone. He tried to redirect. Jenks takes him to the boards, and Dave Masiccio goes back. Masiccio hard off the glass, and it's out at center ice. Blades get it out to center. Gary Emmons. He'll send it over to Paul Dick. Shoot the puck in. Shabbat out of the net. Frederick Shabbat rolls it along the wall. Here is Steve Jenks. He'll move one ahead, and the Arrows are out at center for Alan May. Out of the net, Philip DeRouville. He'll knock it down. Rochefort, he'll clear it himself the length of the ice. We're under 6 minutes to go in the second period. The Blades lead it 4-1. Here's Gary Emmons. Nice pass. Dropped over for Sylvester. Shot deflected. Heads up. It's into the crowd, and it's a souvenir. That thing took off like a missile, and Van grabs it, holds on with 5:41 to go in the second. 4-1, Kansas City.
Mike Hurlbutt coming back from that injury has played well. He's played very well defensively. He's shooting the puck from the point. He just needs some guys to get in front and maybe get a tip or battle for a loose puck. But he has not shown hardly any ill effects from that ankle that was stress fractured.
Pretty well stepped in, did a pretty good job. Face off in the Arrowhead, and false start. They'll try it again. Bill Bowler with Al May and Mike Yeo. Arrows have the puck in their own zone. Kuchera lobs it out at center. Knocked away by Rochefort. Puck goes into the Arrows zone. It's knocked down by Shabbat and Hurl, but it'll go back to play it. Arrows look to break it out from left to right. Kuchera trying to move one ahead. As Don Jackson had a mouthful to give to Jeff Smith, the referee, as he passed right in front of him. Don Jackson's not even on the bench. He's in front of the boards there. In front of the bench, right along the dashers, and he was screaming at him. And he's still yelling at him.
And is that not the same Don Jackson that had the encounter with the Atlanta mascot?
It is one and the same, but right now he is not happy with Jeff Smith. Puck is in to the Kansas City zone. Bill Bowler gathers it, a puck centered. Yo right in, shooting and saving is DeRouville. Nice play between Bowler and Yo, but DeRouville makes the save and he'll hold on. We're under 5 minutes to go in the second period in the Blades with a 3-goal lead. Kansas City Blades with a 4-1 lead with under 5 minutes to go. And a moment ago, Mike Yeo and Bill Bowler communicating with a good scoring chance.
And Mike Yeo ends up getting the shot, but it was a great pass from Bill Bowler. Look at Drouville down in that crouched position. Another French goaltender, a la Frédéric Chabot. All those French goalies like to go down. And Mike Yeo wishing that he could get it up a little higher, but he was in so tight, Drouville was all over it.
Face off to the left side of Philip Drouville. 27-16, the shots faced by Philip Drouville.
How many times have we seen that this year, Adam, where the Arrows really outshoot an opponent real bad, but just have a tough time scoring?
Here's a puck picked up by the Blades. And it's out at center ice. It's been really, I think, the turnovers that have hurt the Arrows tonight more than anything. Puck is in the corner. Here is Ian Boyce in behind the net, looks in front. Boyce waiting, trying to look for a man to pass to. He just sets up behind the net. Boyce still waiting. He's not in any hurry. Now he's tied up along the boards, lost the puck, and Jakes will take over. Here is Guy LaRose. It's cleared out at center, and the Arrows have a 2-on-1. Across the line, it's Lamb, but his pass is picked away by the Blades, and it's cleared down the ice. Jakes. He'll shoot the puck ahead. It goes into the Kansas City zone. Ryan Stacey goes back, and Ian Boyce will take over. And Guy LaRose took one right off the instep, and he is shaken up. He can't put any pressure on that skate. He needs to come off as here is Basigio. Hand it over to Conway. Lead pass. Freer is trying to get there. He's there. Poke check by Drouville. Do you believe it? Freer had it, and then it was poke check by Drouville. If Drouville doesn't poke check that puck, Freer has got a wide open cage. It stays 4-1. Now the puck is centered, and the Arrows turn it around. It is Mike Curlbutt in his own zone. He'll circle back in behind the net. 3:23 to go in the second period. A 4-1 Kansas City lead. At center, Paul Dick shoots it through Tkachuk and into Arrow territory.
And you can see that the Blades are in that 1-2-2-4 check, always having two players back.
Puck is controlled by Freer. And Tkachuk now down the right side. Gary Emmons will go back to play it. Here's Gary Emmons with under 3 minutes to go in the second period. And a three-goal Kansas City lead. Here's Bowler trying to take a puck away. It's held in nicely by Alan May. May moving down, lets a shot go. That was deflected away. Jumped on by Sylvester. He'll crank it, but not out. Held in Basigio. His shot blocked. Paul Dick able to clear it, and it'll go down the ice. 2.5 to go in the second period. And the puck is out at center. Cerrone is there. Bumped by Yeo. It's brought in offsides. With 2:30 to go in the second period and a 4-1 Kansas City lead.
And they're going to take it all the way back. Dave Tippett, I'm sure, is telling his guys.
Now we've got the Kansas City bench getting into it with Alan May. Behind the play, Alan May and the Kansas City bench. May and Doty Wood tied up right now. And the linesman trying to separate those two. I was watching up ice a little bit, but behind the play, Alan May was getting into it with the Kansas City bench. Well, the frustration's starting to set in, and Alan May still barking at the bench a little bit. Barking at Lucien Deblois, who was a very tough customer in his day when he played for the New York Islanders.
Once again, behind the play, Mealy at the bench. And I don't know, Don Jackson's been talking to the ref. He's been upset with the ref, what has been going on. And I don't know if that was just a carryover from that. And Al May mixing it up with Woods in front of the bench.
Face off. We'll be out at center. We've got Wood and May, a couple of number 16s, five each for fighting. So they'll be gone for the remainder of this period and the first 2.5 of the third period.
And the Arrows once again out shooting, getting lots of shots. Drouville's played very well. He's been in a position to make the shots, make the saves from the Arrows. I don't know what the Arrows are going to have to do. I guess he goes down so much at him. Maybe Dave Tippett says, hey, guys, you got to go upstairs.
easy to say from the booth is when you're trying to shoot upstairs, usually defense are pressuring you, makes it a lot tougher.
Right now, Dave Tippett calling Mike Yeo over to the bench. I don't know, Tippett looked upset about something. I don't know what it is, but they'll face it off to the left of DeRouville. 4-1 Kansas City. As it's Cerrone against Bowler, and Cerrone wins the faceoff. Freer shoulder to the corner with Rochefort. Goes to the far side, and now it is John Purvis. He'll send it along the wall. Back to the near side for Rob Valasevic. Centering one, that's tipped away, and that puck sails up over the glass. And out of play with 2:18 to go in the second period.
And they're gonna bring it outside as Bill Bowler deflects the puck up over the glass and did not hit a Kansas City Blade. So that brings it back out to the neutral zone of the ice.
Bowler with Valasevic and Yeo, Jakes and Basigio defensively.
Bill Bowler, a few games ago, just passing 100 career points in his very short career, only a year and 16 games into it.
Steve Jakes moves it out at center. Gives to Purvis. Now Boyce has a lane down the right side. Cuts in, backhander, hit the side of the net. And it's rolled away for Rob Valasevic. Get it out at center. Bowler hits the line. It came in for Yeo, but he was partially hooked on the play from Boyce, or from Purvis. Here is Valasevic. Rob Valasevic slides it down to DeRouville. Came out to play it. Bowler knocked it away. It swung along the wall by Jim Kite, and it's swept down at center by Ian Boyce. 1:43 to go in the second. 4-1 Kansas City. Rochefort shoots it in, stick save made by Chabot, and Basigio will clear it out at center. Yeo dumped the puck in, DeRouville out of the net, and he'll just send it along the boards as the Arrows making changes. Colleton tied up by Freer, it came to Tkachuk. He had that popped away. Here's a shot by Kuchera wide. And in there is Craigwell. Conroy has it. Al Conroy trying to center one, and it's pushed out at center ice. Conroy lost it. Moving in is Craigwell trying to shake off the check from Conroy, and he was able to get a shot away. What a battle between Craigwell and Al Conroy.
Those guys battled for approximately 5-6 seconds. Craigwell finally getting a shot off, but Al Conroy sticking on him like glue. He could not get that good quality shot. This is hustle by Al Conroy to get back and hard work by Craigwell. These are one-on-one battles that you'd call a draw because Al Conroy does his job and forces him for a bad angle shot.
Face off right side of Frederick Chabot. Off the draw, it is Mike Hurlbutt that will play. And the Arrows are up ice. Hurlbutt a pass, tipped away. And it's turned around by, well, Kansas City had a chance. It's knocked away to Conroy. Brought in, Tkachuk tried to advance it, but it's shot right back to Brian Culleton. He'll move out at center ice. Culleton hits the line. Kuchera is back. Culleton centered one. Chabot steers that right over to Mark Frears. We're down to 45 seconds to play in the second period. 4-1 Kansas City. Puck is into the Kansas City zone. Mark Freer moving down the right side. Quick shot. Stopped by DeRouville. It's in front. What a save by DeRouville! He outstretched that right foot and made perhaps the save of the year. A right toe save by DeRouville. The Arrows with a wide open net as I think Tkachuk was the one that was robbed. Oh my word, are you kidding me or what? Here is Tkachuk again, across the line, in with a chance, shot went wide. It'll go along the boards, and Gary Emmons will move it up and out at center ice. It's drilled in by Rochefort, right on, Chabot will play it, and that will be the period. But what a save by Philip DeRouville. He makes one unbelievable save, and then Tkachuk all alone on the doorstep, and Philip DeRouville with a right pad save, and those are the saves that win you hockey games. Wow!
Especially at that time, Adam, with only 10 seconds left in the period, Gary Tkachuk could have made it a 4-2 game, but DeRouville with that right foot denied him.
All right, some chapstick due for DeRouville as he's standing on his lips. 4-1 Kansas City. We'll have more after we toss it to the clubhouse. We'll be right back.
A
4-1 hockey game after two periods of play from the Summit. The Blades leading the Houston Arrows. Adam Gordon along with Troy Gamble. And we were talking a little bit during the break of that intermission there that actually the Arrows, not a bad period, just the mistakes that they made really cost them. It seems like they were glaring mistakes.
Well, those big mistakes, those big turnovers usually come back to haunt you, and that's what happened that period. But they did have a lot of quality shots on Drewville. They just could not bury the puck. Hopefully this period coming up, they'll get some more of those same scoring chances.
And we'll look at the save of the year of later here in the highlight package that Drewville made. But, I mean, that could be your game winner right there, because if the Arrows score on that, it's 4-2 heading into the intermission.
And I'm sure Dave Tippett would love to have that one back. Gary Tkachuk did get the good shot away, but Drewville was up to the task, as he was most of that period. He uses his size. He uses that butterfly style. Very tough to beat.
And that takes us to our Dodge scoring summary, brought to you by your local Texas Dodge dealers. Back in the first period, Jason Cerrone, an unassisted goal, fifth of the year at 2:16. And then Tony Wood made it 2-0 with his second of the year at 7:52. Neil Craigwell and Claudio Scrimmon getting the assist. 3-0 Kansas City on the power play with a nice goal from John Purvis at 15:46. Brian Stacey and Claudio Scrimmon getting the assist. You move to the second period, and a very glaring mistake again by the Arrows hurt them as Gary Emmons got a shorthanded goal with 1 second remaining in the Arrows power play, seventh of the year at 6:10, unassisted for Emmons. And then Mark Freer got a nice goal, his third at 7:52 from Al Conroy, and the Kansas City Blades have a 4-1 lead. Frederick Chabot had a rough first period, but he started to settle down a little bit in the second.
Well, Mike Hurlbutt breaks his stick, and all of a sudden the guy jumps out of the box. Watch this save. This save was at the very start of the period. Very key save. Frederick Chabot did not give up an inch of the net, and those are the type of saves he needs. Then Gary Emmons, though, comes back to miscommunication between Al Conroy and Wierenka. Next thing you know, Emmons jumps on the loose puck. Blasted five hole for the fourth shorthanded goal the Blades scored this year.
So Gary Emmons picks up the goal, but on the other side of things, Philip Drewville had some nice saves.
Well, he gets on the top of the crease here and pulls out that big goalie glove, snaps it up in the air. He actually made that one look a little bigger than what it was. But then Mark Freer is going to find the net on a good pass from Al Conroy. He one-times it right away. Looked like it went off the side of Jim Kite in front of the net. It doesn't really matter. It finds the net behind Drewville.
And the Arrows are down 4-1. They had a chance to make it 4-2. Watch this save.
Mark Freer takes the initial shot. What a shot on net. That traffic in front. The loose puck. Gary Tkachuk is going to shoot it. And the toe save of Drewville. The presence of mind to keep his foot on the ice. Mark Freer, the traffic. This is picture perfect what you want to do. But Drewville keeps his eye on the puck and kicks out his right foot. What a just a tremendous save.
Yeah, you know, you look at it, and it's not as spectacular as maybe when you first thought, because he happened to have his foot in position. But I think the key was, Troy, was that he was able to keep it in the position and keep sight of the puck. He never lost it after being run into.
Well, especially when you got Al Conroy and Jim Kite battling in front of you. He kept that right foot on the ice to make him in that position to make the save. That is what made it so spectacular.
All right, 4-1, the Kansas City Blades lead it after 40 minutes of play. And when Troy and I return, we'll have the period stats. We'll be back. A 4-1 hockey game, Kansas City Blades leading the Arrows. And let's quickly take a look at tonight's second period stats, brought to you by our local Texas Jeep and Eagle dealer. 29-19, the shots on goal in favor of the Arrows. Arrows 0 for 5 on the power play. Blades 1 of 2 on the man advantage. And the faceoffs 26-23 in favor of the Houston Arrows. Arrows returning to the ice, ready for period 3 when we return. 4-1 Kansas City. We'll be right back.
There's lots of places that you would like to see.
Fly Southwest Airlines, because friends fly free.
Fly so you can learn.
Fly so you can earn.
For romance.
Give it a chance.
Fly so you can dance.
Fly so you can cry.
Fly so you can yell.
Fly because it's something that you were born to sell.
Fly, because it's America.
From sea to shining sea.
And if you fly Southwest Airlines,
your friend flies free.
Purchase fall unrestricted fare by November 20th and a friend flies free.
Thank you.
See your Texas Jeep and Eagle dealer.
When you penetrate, you're like a missile, headed straight at the heart of the enemy. There's nothing they can do to stop.
Jackson pulls his way.
You can dish.
Jason to Jimmy. Whoa!
Jam or lay it up soft. Driving to the hoop breaks the back of the defense. It challenges their manhood. It crushes their confidence.
Jimmy Jackson has just taken over this game.
You are their worst nightmare.
Jim Jackson and the Mavericks face the Timberwolves Thursday at 7 on the all-new Fox Sports Southwest. Pacers take on Wilkins and the Spurs. The Spurs and Pacers Friday at 7:30 on Fox Sports Southwest. Forget what you think about women's basketball and prepare yourself for battle, the NIT preseason semifinals. This Ain't No Fashion Show, Tuesday at 6 on Fox Sports Southwest.
Underway with the third period. A 4-1 Kansas City lead, and Dave Basigio sets up from behind the net.
And the Arrows are going to see a lot of this now. The 1-2-2 forecheck. Very passive forecheck by the Kansas City Blades.
And an icing call coming up to the Arrows as Kansas City touches. And a faceoff back down into the Arrow end. And Philip DeRouville definitely making his presence felt this hockey game.
Well, he's played very well, but you have to give credit to the Blades defense. It's not as if the Arrows don't want to get in front of the net. They are working very hard to get in front of the net. They're just blocking out very well.
Let's go down to Rob Dobson. Dobber, what was your thoughts of DeRouville? Was he the difference in that period?
Sorry?
Did you think Philip DeRouville was the difference in that second period?
Well, I think so. A lot of the times, Adam, he gets in good position, and he's a big kid when he's down on his knees, and the top of the net is covered very good. Unfortunately, we had a couple of chances that we didn't put away. There's one there at the end of the period where he hit his skate. So we had some good opportunities. I think that's why we've stayed pretty positive throughout the whole contest.
Thanks, Dobber. Mark Freer has it. He'll move it out at center ice. And now Al Conroy crossed the line. That's rolled away and cleared out at center. And Kuchera will go back to play. It is Basigio in his own zone. Hands it over to Kuchera. He'll send it up the boards. And Freer trying to chop away at it. And it's brought in by Shuchuk, but that's offside. Play whistle down. You know, going back to DeRouville, talking with the Kansas City Blades, Doug Sotart, a lot of guys on the team, they felt since Philip DeRouville has come over, he's been the kind of the boost for him, period. He's had just the one bad outing at home against Cleveland, but other than that, he has played very, very well, and his 4-4-1 record is not indicative of how well he really played.
Well, when you have a 2.59 goals against and a 91.9 save percent, you're stopping a lot of pucks. And as Rob Dobson alluded to, he uses his size so much. But the one thing, if we get the shot of his goalie pads are like 42 inches. And that is unheard of. Rob Dobson wearing 36-inch goalie pads.
Puck is shot down along the boards into the Kansas City zone. Battling his lamb, but Sylvester able to clear it out at center. And here comes David Bruce. He'll shoot the puck into Arrow territory. And after it, Sylvester swings along the boards. Ryan Stacey moving down the left side. And that's rolled along for David Bruce. Paul Dick trying to hold it in. It came out at center, and it's jumped on by Mark Gregg. He'll shoot it in, but Brian Stacey had it. Lost it, but David Bruce able to play it. Here come the Blades across the line. It'll go to the corner. Hurlbutt is back. And Hurlbutt will shoot it along the wall up to Mark Lamb. Center ice pass for Gregg. He'll come in across with LaRose, and he'll dump it in. Gregg rattled by Stacey with a little bit of a check. It's out to center ice. Kuchera will play it over to Steve Jakes. Ryan Stacey going back, had it in his skates, cleared it out at center. Craigwell moving it down across the line. He'll cut in. Craigwell behind the net. He centered it. Yo was able to deflect it. It's out to center ice for Bill Bowler. Now the arrow, Steve Jakes, has two guys to beat instead. Lets a shot go and a blocker save made by DeRouville. Firstweiler up for Craigwell. And now Ian Boyce across the line. Sends it for Craigwell. Wrist shot saved made by Shabbat. Bang away at it. Shabbat there to make another save. And it's taken back by Frank Kuchera. Puck is out at center. Bill Bowler down the right wing. Pulls up. Centered. Here's a chance for Valasevic. Too far. Puck is controlled by Firstweiler. And it goes in. Batted down by Basigio. And he'll move it up ice. Lucigio up the bowler, shoots the puck into the Kansas City zone, out of the net to Ruville. Jimmy Kite, he'll throw it along the boards, and Jason Cerrone will move it to center ice. Missing Purvis with a pass. It would be icing if the Arrows could get there, but Shabbat forced to play it because Purvis was ahead of everybody. And that negated icing. Puck is in the Arrow end. Freer handed in skates. Mark Freer with the lone Arrows tally. Freer sends it over for Al Conroy. He'll scamper up and out at center ice. Shoots the puck in. That went off of Brian Stacey. Mark Freer regroups at center. And Hurlbutt turns it around. Hurlbutt hoists it into Kansas City territory. It's in front. Shoot, Chuck fanned on it. Purvis lost it. Here's Conroy, the drive. And a great glove save made by Deruville, and he will hold on. Timeout on the ice. 4-1 Kansas City. Back after this word from Southwest Airlines. A 4-1 Kansas City lead, but don't let it be said, Troy. The Arrows haven't had chances tonight.
Well, a good cross-corner dump, lack of communication on the Blades' defense. Gary Shutruck tries to one-time it, just misses it. But who's there is Al Conroy, who's going to get the loose puck. Makes a good soccer-style kick, keeps it in front of him. Deruville on top of that crease with that glove going down to his knees. He's about 6'3.5". When he goes down, he still keeps that upper body so upright that he looks so big in that net. Al Conroy trying to get a good shot away, got one away, just could not beat him.
Face off to the right side of Philip Deruville. Paul Dick goes back, slides it along the boards, over to David Brusitz out of center, knocked away by Wawrinka. But he shot it right to Gary Emmons. He'll bring it across the line, shot right on, Shabbat stopped it. And it's turned around by Darcy Wawrinka. Wawrinka in his own zone. The pass for Gary Shutruck. He'll dump it in. Deruville comes out. Play it away. Over to Ian Boyce. Tied up by Shutruck. Battle on the boards. Conroy's there. And it's cleared out at center ice and back into Arrow territory. And it hits the stick of David Bruce, who he lost. He lost the stick there a moment ago. 4 minutes gone in the third and a 4-1 Kansas City lead. Ian Boyce shoots the puck in. Shabbat comes out of the net. Swings it over to Conroy. Al Conroy hands it over to Hurlbutt. And LaRose will go back to play. E. LaRose steers one ahead. Can Lamb play that? Yeah, he could. Barely. I saw the Arrows making a change there and almost too many men, but Mark Lamb made sure the guys were off. That was a smart play. Puck in the corner. Greg. It's picked up by Rochefort. Jammed along the boards. It came out in front, and Deruville taking no chances, and he will hold on.
And how frustrating is it for Dave Tippett? Because when a team gets up on that three-goal lead, they play the 1-2-2 system, which means the Arrows really have to get it in deep and get a lot of pressure.
It's time now to announce our winner in the Watch and Win contest, Anna Lisa Millette of Humble. Congratulations to Anna Lisa. She's won a sportsman vacation courtesy of Southwest Airlines Academy and Ace Travel House. And I don't know, maybe Anna Lisa, I don't know if she's got plans to take anybody with her. If not, Troy, you want to go?
Well, I'm pretty busy being stuck here with you, Adam, all year.
Stuck?
So.
Stuck? Come on. Stuck?
Well, yeah, I'm stuck with you. You're stuck with me,
wow.
Though, too.
Wow, maybe somebody ought to step forth and put you on a vacation.
After a year with you, Adam, we're going to take a long one.
Oh, brother. Face off left side of Deruville. Gamble, you never had a gray hair in your head till you met me. Puck goes back down to Frederick Shabbat.
And I noticed that in the monitor tonight, my one side is going a little gray.
Oh, you're out of control. Puck is out at center ice. And Ian Boyce will send it back into the Kansas City zone. 4-1 Kansas City, 5 minutes gone in the third period. Firstweiler out at center. Ian Boyce across the line. Breaking ahead was Craigwell, but he was offside, and they'll bring the faceoff back out at center.
And the one thing about this system now the Blades are using is that if the Arrows force too much, what ends up happening is the Blades will start getting outnumbered situations, but the Arrows are in a catch-22. You have to force, but you still might have to give up those chances because you need to get chances at them. And I'm sure Jackson's saying, guys, if you play this system, you're going to get some scoring chances. Just don't give the Arrows outnumbered situations. That's what they don't want to do. And that's what the Arrows are looking for.
Puck is sent back, and to Arrow territory, and Dave Vesigio will take over. Vesigio fires it up at center. It goes back, and it's out of play. The Arrows will have a day off tomorrow. They will practice, as will the Blades, at the Aerodrome. And then Friday night, these two teams will go back at it once again.
And it should be another battle. These teams seem to have a history of playing very good games. And this has not been a bad game by any means. It's just that when the Arrows have made those big, costly turnovers, the Blades have put it in the net.
And that was one of the things we talked about, defensive zone coverage, turnovers. And, you know, I still think, you know, the Arrows would like to see a little stronger game from Freddie Chabot. But a couple of them, he's hard to fault on. Here come the Arrows. Bill Poehler shoots it in as Drouville will play.
Well, the one thing is that with a lot of the shots on the rolls that Frederick has got by him, is that the Blades have just had too much time to pick the corners. The Arrows don't get as much time.
Bill Poehler trying to work one down. John Purvis had it taken away by Alan May. Make it to Rowenko had it taken away. He was looking for May. Block is pushed away. Brian Stacey swings one along the boards. Can it get to center? No, held in by Vesigio. Nice play. Sends one down, shot. Oh, that changed direction as Drouville got a piece of it. Purvis can't clear. And there's Brian Stacey. He and Al May go at it along the boards. Now Bill Poehler trying to center one. Poehler stuffed one in there. Stop. Another stop shot. And there's Drouville again. I don't know what it's going to take to beat Philip Drouville. And now Alan May getting into it again after the whistle.
What Drouville does so well is he gets his paddle of his stick, the whole entire paddle of his stick, down on the ice. And once he gets it down on the ice, there's nowhere to beat him along the ice. But it's so tough to go upstairs. You have Cerrone all over Bill Poehler. Where's he going to go with it? And that is just a very smart play by the goaltender, knowing that Bill Poehler is not going to go upstairs. If he takes away all the ice, where can the Arrows score? And that's what has made him very successful, not tonight, but for the whole entire year. As I understand, the goaltender has played very smart, Philip Drouville.
You might remember seeing Philip Drouville in a Pittsburgh Penguin uniform in late September when the Arrows had their NHL exhibition game, the Detroit Red Wings and Pittsburgh Penguins. He played the first half of that game, and not too bad. Or actually, he played the second half of the game.
So does that mean it was bad? I didn't come to the game.
No, he did okay.
He did okay?
Patrick Laleem, who was his goaltending partner in Cleveland, played the first half. Is out at center ice. David Bruce shoots it into Arrow territory, and Mike Hurlbutt will have it. Shuffle a pass over to Kuchera. Out at center, and here comes Gary Tkachuk. Across the line, the pass. Conroy shooting. Deflected just wide. Tkachuk again trying to center one. Tkachuk had it go off skate. Gary Tkachuk looks in front. He again tried to center. Blades are giving him absolutely nowhere to pass the puck, and it's out at center ice. Arrows trying to get themselves back into this thing, but as soon as there's a passing lane, the Blades are all over them.
And that's totally correct, Adam. You say passing lane. As soon as they get a passing or shooting lane, the Blades are sprawling all over the ice, and they're closing it down so quick, a la what the Arrows did the other night when they had success.
Mark Lamb hoisted down. That's going to draw a Blade penalty, and the Arrows will be on the power play. And when we return, 12:52 to go, third period. The Arrows with a chance when we come back. Questions of tonight's game are brought to you by the Gatorade Company. You live life, you get thirsty. Life's a sport, drink it up. 4-1 Kansas City. And 2 minutes up on the board to Dale Craigwell for hooking, and the Arrows will get another power play, and you know, and still enough time if they can score here to try and get themselves back into this thing.
Well, there's lots of time, but what happens here, very good play by Mark Land, just driving and using speed, getting hauled down, and that's how you have to attack the 1-2-2 forecheck. Craigwell ends up hooking Mark Lamb, but he had to because Mark Lamb had so much speed.
It's a 4-1 Blade lead, and Arrows have the puck. Make that mark. Greg behind the net. Greg setting up on the power play. Scoops it down. Bill Poehler trying to find the handle on it. Poehler waiting, centered. Came back to the line for Darcy Wawrinka. Here is a pass along the boards for Lamb. Getting set. cuts one over. It's deflected away. Now a shot hammered just wide by Greg. Lock along the boards. Greg trying to loosen it up. Good battle there. Here is Mark Greg, circles back. Greg with a puck, and we've got another whistle, and that'll do it for the Arrow power play as Basigio gets tied up with Ferschweiler, and that will be the end of the Arrow power play.
Jeff Smith whistling Basigio for interference, trying to run a little pick play. Basigio, 2 minutes. He's trying to help out Mark Greg here to keep the puck. Just gets a little over anxious. He's gonna go for 2 minutes. We had a great conversation before the game with Doug Sotard, who was a great goalie in the National Hockey League. We were talking about goaltending in the IHL. 14 of the top goaltenders in the IHL have save percents better than 90%. You can go back 3 years ago in the IHL, there might have been one or two goalies over 90%. The goaltending has improved so much, but he believes it's the defense in the IHL that has improved so much.
It is Sean Purvis who'll shoot the puck ahead as 2 minutes up on the board to Basigio, and the puck going out of play. So we'll go 4-on-4 for a minute 19. Then Cragwell returns to the ice, and the Arrows will get 34 seconds to work on the power play.
Purvis showing a little bit of his old flash when he was in the San Francisco organization, scoring 54 goals, showing that quick release, quick shot.
With Freer. Defensively, Wawrinka and Kucherov. Puck is into the Kansas City zone. Wawrinka trying to send it down for Bowler. Bill Bowler getting sent back to line. Wawrinka tees it up, shot blocked. Freer gives chase to it. Here's Mark Freer, scooped it down for Bill Bowler. Bowler trying to move to the slot. Bowler has a lane. Here is Bowler, but now they're going to call a penalty. We saw the interference in the first period, and I think Wawrinka is going to get nailed for obstruction interference as he threw a pick, a moving pick on Paul Dick, and that will negate that. Now the Blades are going to get a two-man advantage, but first they'll go 4-on-3.
And I'll be honest, Adam, I wonder about this call. Wawrinka just never gave any ground. He stood still. He did not move to a position on the ice to run a pick. He just did not give up his ice. So he stands there, Bill Bowler going. Wawrinka just stopping. I don't know, that's a close call. I think that's a close call.
Well, regardless, it is going to be a penalty to Darcy Wawrinka for obstruction interference. And the Arrows will be down 4-on-3. And then in 55 seconds, they'll be two men down for 49 seconds.
And I guess I should say, in Jeff Smith's defense, the referee, is that he's called that penalty a couple times tonight, the obstruction. So he's been looking for it tonight, those little pick and roll plays. From his point of view, that was obstruction.
I don't know what the wait is here. I think Dave Tippett just wanted to see who the Blades bring out. They've got five guys out there. They can only have four. And now Paul Dick will come to the bench. And Dave Tippett is screaming at Jeff Smith, the referee. I don't know. Tippett is pretty animated right now.
Well, he just wanted to make sure that the Blades had their four guys on the ice before he was going to throw his players on the ice. And I don't think he was happy about the call on Wawrinka either. So he was just trying to make his point to Smith, saying, hey, I'm not happy with that call. I don't think that was a penalty.
Yeah, I guess Dave Tippett just, we had talked to Rob Dobson through our intercom system to find out that it's more just complaining about the call. That's what Dave Tippett's upset about. Puck goes down the ice, and here's John Purvis moving in. He'll set up on the power play. It's 4-on-3 for 48 seconds. Puck is Norman Rochefort at the left point. Let's a shot go. That made it through. Shabbat got a piece of it, and Gary Shuchuk will just wait and then shoot at the length of the ice. Blades will go back to play. 33 seconds left, and then Cragwell's on the ice, and it's a 5-on-3 for 49 seconds. Rochefort across the line. That's blasted away by Kuchera and right back down the ice. Rouville comes out of the net. And there's 15 seconds remaining in the penalty to Cragwell. Ryan Stacey at center ice. Hands it over to Paul Dick. He'll bring it across the line, shoot it into the Arrow territory. In 6 seconds, it'll be a two-man advantage for Kansas City. Puck is jammed along the boards. It's skipped over Brian Stacey. It's out at center. So now the two-man advantage for the Kansas City Blades. Puck goes in. Conroy, can he clear it? He'll give it a ride along the boards, and it did make its way to center ice. 20 seconds left to Basigio's penalty, and on the two-man advantage. David Bruce across the line, sets up on the 5-on-3. Back to line, intercepted by Conroy. Conroy breaks out with it. Conroy across the line, shorthanded. Looks for a man to pass to. Instead, he'll just go back out at center and try and kill off the two-man advantage. It's a smart play by Al Conroy. I think some guys would be tempted being down to maybe take a chance, but when you're down two men, here's a puck that takes a weird hop off the boards. What a tough break for Al Conroy. Makes a perfect play, goes back, shoots it off the boards, it hits a weird part on the glass, and it, you know, the funny thing is if you're a coach, you call that a turnover. I mean, the guy makes the right play, shoots it off the boards, it hits a weird part, and the Blades get a scoring chance.
Well, Al Conroy does exactly what he should have done. He ragged the puck all over the ice, then he goes to blast it off, it hits a partition, ends up on a Blade stick, he goes to shoot it, the puck ends up rolling, he puts it 20 rows into the stands. Al Conroy doing the proper thing, blasting it hard, high off the glass. It hits one of the partitions, bounces at a 90 degree angle under the Blade stick. Tit for tat, the puck rolls and he throws it out of the rink.
Here's Hemmings behind the net. About 15 seconds left on the power play for Kansas City. Yeah. Puck shot down to the corner. Bruce tied up by Basigio. Jenks is there and he will clear it himself all the way back down the ice.
Very good job by the Arrows penalty killer so far and jumping on all the loose pucks.
Here's Bowler cutting in. As the penalty is over, teams are five aside. And it's picked up by Guy LaRose. Arrows bring it across. Mark Lamb looks in front. Centered for LaRose. That's played beautifully by Jim Kite. Well, I'll tell you what, you got to give the Blades a lot of credit. They have played a smart, heady hockey game tonight. They have not given the Arrows much. Here's a chance in front, and LaRose couldn't get there. Now a shot right on, and DeRouville will hold on to it, and play is whistled down. 9:22 to go in the third, and the Blades with a 4-1 lead. Academy Sports and Outdoors presents the Houston Arrows Fan Pack. This offer entitles you to one Houston Arrows ticket, one hot dog, and a small soft drink at the Summit for just $10. Stop by any Academy Sports and Outdoors and pick up a coupon today. No purchase necessary. Remember, there isn't a better way to enjoy an Arrows hockey game than with your Academy Sports and Outdoors Fan Pack. Well, there is one better way. That's watching it with Troy.
And Dave Basigio is going to have a very good shot here. But DeRouville, who has that big glove, ends up making a good save on it. He shoots this pretty hard. Top of the crease once again, down in that low stance.
Blade shoots the puck into the Arrow end. Shabbat chipped it out to the line, and the Arrows will turn it around. It's Gary Tkachuk. Pass for Darcy Werwanka, and he will, I don't know where he was going with that one. I think it might have been deflected a little bit by Ian Boyce, and that puck goes out of play. 9:04 to go, and a 4-1 Blade lead.
Darcy Werwanka trying to get it in deep, ends up going off a stick. Darcy Werwanka, who won a gold medal at the 1993 World Juniors, ended up being a second pick, 37th overall by the Rangers. Has some offensive capability. I asked him about his face there. He ended up getting a high stick last game. Few marks on his face from that high stick.
Aldick shoots the puck along the boards. It's out at center ice, and the Arrows will regroup. Darcy Werwanka able to clear it out at center. It's batted back into the Kansas City zone. And Brian Stacey will go back and shoot it along the boards and out at center. And here comes Crankwell, 2-on-2. Crankwell across the line, trying to spring Firstweiler. The pass behind him. Firstweiler gathers it in. Trying to center it, but Tkachuk will skate away with it. Gary Tkachuk with some deft skating in behind the net. And he'll look to break out with it. Gary Tkachuk. He'll skate it up and out at center. Dump the puck into the Kansas City zone. Going back is Norman Rochefort. He's there. And play whistle down. 8:16 to go. And a 4-1 Blade lead. The Blades leading with 8:16 to go.
Norman Rochefort, who 667 games in the NHL, but has won a couple Turner Cups, one with Atlanta, won with Denver in 95, won a few championships down in the IHL.
Off the faceoff, the Arrows have got it. Here is Basigio, and now Frank Kuchera will take it. It's out at center, 3-on-2. Mike Yeo hits the line with Bowler. Yeo dropped it, Bowler the shot, glove saved by Deruville, and he will hold on to it. He had to because Al May was crashing the net.
How many times tonight do you think, Adam, you've said glove save?
And it's time for our high-low highlight brought to you by High-Low Auto Supply. What you need is high-low, and this is your high-low highlight of the game.
Mike Yeo getting the puck back for the one-timer from Bill Bowler. Another glove save. I would imagine that is a dozen times tonight he's ate up the puck with that glove. I wonder if it's the same model of Rob Dobson's. Rob Dobson loves his gloves so much. Oh, there's a Heaton. No, that's not Rob Dobson. Not as good as Rob Dobson, but he's making well with that glove tonight. Philip Drouville is.
Again, you think you like Dobson's glove as much as he does?
Well, maybe if I had one, I might have been able to play a couple more years. It's an unbelievable glove.
Here's a shot by Basigio, stuck aside by Deruville, and it's picked up by Yeo. Turned one down. The centering pass went through the skates of Rochefort and Kite. It's back out at center ice. Arrows are back. Bowler slides it in, and Jim Kite regroups back into his own end. Here's Dave Basigio. He'll send it over to Frank Kuchera. And it's brought in. But turned around now by John Purvis. He's got a two-on-one with Doty Wood. Purvis over to Wood, right in. Purvis, or Wood went upstairs, and that puck deflected. It goes up out of play with 7:26 to go in the third. 4-1 in Kansas City.
Wood hitting the puck up high again. But the whole entire play comes from the system that the Blades are using, is that the Arrows need to be aggressive. They have to take chances. What ends up happening, you give two-on-ones, maybe a three-on-one. This is a two-on-one with Purvis, makes the nice pass over to Wood. Wood ends up shooting it up high. Puck was rolling on him. Puts it about 10 rows into the Summit seats.
Off the faceoff, Houston's got it. Jakes shoots one into the Kansas City zone. Paul Dick going back. Shot along the boards. And Kansas City's got it. Out at center, Sylvester. Nice pass. Emmons cutting right in, shooting, and that was whistled wide of the net. Arrows have it. And Mark Lamb will get it back into the Kansas City zone. In there is Mark Gregg. He tried to advance the puck, batting away at it. Dean Sylvester had it. He lost it. Here is a chance. LaRose, the shot and a blocker save made by Deruville. Oh, has he been unbelievable tonight? Puck is shot in by Jakes. Here's LaRose trying to turn one down for Gregg in the corner. Dean Sylvester collide. Lamb gives to Gregg. It got through his stick. Mark Gregg. Worked it back to the line. Here's Hurl, but a shot right on. Stopped by Deruville. Puck cuts in behind the net. Mark Lamb. Lamb waiting. Looks in front. He centered one. It bounced through. It'll come back to the point. Hurl, but turning with a drive. Block. And it's rolled away. Guy LaRose. Gives it over to Mark Gregg. Worked it back down the left side for LaRose. Here is Lamb. 6:09 to go in the third period. Mark Gregg. Cross-ice pass, Hurlbutt lets a shot go. That was deflected away. LaRose in the corner. Now a chance for Gregg, cutting in. Looks to stuff it in there. Mark Lamb sends it back to the line. Here is Jakes. Jakes trying to shake off. He's hauled down by Sylvester. I don't know why Sylvester would take a penalty like that. It would team up 4-1, 5:47 to play. I mean, Jakes wasn't really in any big scoring chance, but he'll take the penalty, and the Arrows will get a power play. Thank you very much.
Well, I don't think that was a very tough call, was it, Adam? He just bear hugs him. He had lost his stick earlier, and he says, Steve Jakes, you're not getting by me. I'm hauling you down. I'm tired. And I don't care if I have to go to my bench or the penalty box. A whistle is going to happen. Sylvester not making a good play, but with 5 minutes and 47 seconds left on the clock, it's not as big as or bad as a penalty if that happened in the first period.
Šuchák with Freer and Conroy, CGO and Kuchera defensively.
And look for the arrows, Adam, to really put some pressure here. They really need to build on getting the power play going, as the Blades have been very good on their penalty kill.
Puck is shot back down as the Arrows on the power play, and it's rolled ahead. Arrows bring it out at center ice. Here is Conroy trying to fish one over for Tkachuk. Work back Conroy, tipped it back to the line for Dave Bisiggio. Bisiggio poked it down Conroy, but that's knocked away by Furschweiler and back out at center ice. You know, I'm looking over and there's Claudio Scrimmon in street clothes. And I didn't see, I noticed we hadn't called his name, and I didn't think he was playing that poorly as the Arrows are offsides. But I didn't know he was banged up. We have not gotten a report as to his injury.
And I believe he already has two assists tonight in the game. He must have got banged up either earlier in this period or late in the second period.
To go in the third period. And a 4-1 Blade lead. I hope it's not a serious injury to Claudio Scrimmon. Pretty classy guy, and you hate to see him get banged up. We've talked about it before. Him and I have one thing in common. He's a licensed pilot, as I am myself, and was hoping one chance maybe to go up flying with him. Not in a lot of time, even though they've got the day off here tomorrow, but maybe if we get a day off in Kansas City. He's a terrific pilot from what I understand. Here's Hurlbutt across the line. Hurlbutt moving down. Hurlbutt all on the board. Cerrone able to boom that the length of the ice and back down to Shabbat. A minute to go in the Arrow power play.
And with talking to Doug Sotart, the last two games in Quebec, he felt that this team was really starting to take on a lot of character. They played very well up in Quebec. They came away with one win and one shootout loss, but taking 3 points on the road is excellent anytime in the IHL. And Mark Lamb looking around in 84 IHL games, Adam, he has 89 points. That's way better than a point a game. Mark Lamb has played very well at the IHL level with stats like that. And especially with those new duties of his as player assistant. And now we have a stick measurement going on, Adam, over on the far side.
Well, this is a smart call by Dave Tippett. I mean, you got 47 seconds left, 4:34 left. You're not hurting anything. If you take a penalty, except you would be shorthanded for about a minute 13. But looks like they're going to keep the stick. I don't know what they were measuring. And right now it looks like the Arrows are going to get a power play.
Minor penalty.
And it is going to be
playing with an illegal stick. I don't know if they were measuring. I think they were measuring the width of the blade. I'm not quite sure. Yeah, good call. Dave Tippett, no quit in him or the Arrows.
No.
They played well this period, Adam. They've just had a tough time getting the puck by Derulé, and it's just very tough when he is so big in there, and they have to go now into that good posture of having a 5-on-3, hopefully scoring in the first 47 seconds, and then still having a minute 23 left over on a power play. Who knows what can happen?
So Doherty Wood is in the box for having an illegal stick, and the Arrows will get a two-man advantage. We've gotten an update on Claudio Scrimmon. I guess he twisted his ankle, and he had re-injured it a little bit there in the second period, just hurt it too much. So obviously that's one of those day-to-day kind of things, and they'll see if he's ready to go on Friday. But the Arrows ready to go on a two-man advantage. Mark Lamb through the neutral zone, brings it across the line. Lamb getting set on the power play. Mark Lamb over to Wawrinka. Wawrinka steers it down, back over to Wawrinka, top of the slot. Here's Tkachuk. If the Arrows can hurry, they'd stay on the power play if they can score. Here's Wawrinka. 3:20 remaining in the two-man advantage. Wawrinka steers it down for Tkachuk. Tkachuk working the perimeter, back to the line, Wawrinka. Here's Lamb, one-time shot, and he blistered it wide of the net, and that'll go all the way out at center ice. Wawrinka Sends it over to Mark Lamb. That's a two-line pass. And they'll bring the faceoff back down into the arrow end.
Wierenka thought he had gained the blue line before he made that pass to Mark Lamb. Obviously, he did not. That's a flustered Dave Tippett looking there.
I think flustered is the understatement. He just, he talked to Dave Tippett, and he sees these signs that makes him think things are going to start coming together. You get that team effort against Phoenix, and you know, Dave Tippett was the first to say, he says, hey, that's a great team effort. We played well, but we also played Phoenix, the team with the worst record in the IHL. But he felt that the way his team played showed signs, and if they continued to play like that, they'd have no problem beating the other teams they've got to face. But tonight, he was getting inconsistent efforts out of his club, I would say. And then, of course, we've touched upon the big mistakes that his team has made tonight.
Well, that's what's killed them tonight, are the big turnovers at the wrong time.
Kansas City shoots at the length of the ice, the two-man advantage history. And there's 59 seconds remaining in the Dodie Wood penalty. Basigio. Over to Mike Hurlbut, steers one for Conroy. It goes down into the Kansas City zone. Paul Dick able to clear that down the ice. So Dave Basigio will go back to play with 3:11 to go in this one and a 4-1 Blade lead.
Arrows just having a whale of a time to get the puck set up in the Blade zone.
Puck is shot in. Conroy trying to move it down along the right wing boards to Mark Craig. Worked it back, but it came right over to Dean Sylvester. And it's right back down the ice.
And you can see now the Blades have played this system all period, that the Arrows are starting to look tired because they have to take the play 200 feet all the time and do all the skating. The Blades are just sitting back waiting for turnovers.
Cerrone fired it into Arrow territory, and Shabbat will slow it for Frank Kuchera. The penalty is over to Dodie Wood. Teams are at five aside. Puck is at center. Here come the Arrows across the line. Wierenka moving in. He centered one, but it was off the stick of Rochefort. Blasted over to John Purvis. He'll move it out. 3-on-2. Purvis gives to Dodie Wood across the line, but Purvis ahead of the playoff sides. We take timeout. 4-1 Blades. We're back after this.
The reason hockey is so cool is that there are so many ways to score a goal. The powerful slap shot, the deceptive and quick wrist shot, and the surprisingly accurate backhand. All demonstrated here by Anaheim Mighty Ducks player Paul Kariya, one of the league's most dangerous offensive players.
Hey, any more of that, you keep a waiting a car.
Paul trains constantly to give him the competitive edge. The NHL on Fox Sports Net. Home teams, Fox attitude.
Any way you play it, the whole new line of Plymouths is a whole lot of fun.
Kansas City, 2:15 to go, and it's time for our Gatorade play of the game. And what a save of the game.
Well, it started with a shot by Mark Freer, who shoots it on goal. The rebound's going to be sitting there, and you're going to see the big right leg, or I should say right toe, of the goalie kicking it out. Drillville kicking it out. That would have made 4-2, I believe, going in for the start of the third period. Instead, it's 4-1, and they've played this defensive system the whole entire period.
Wierenka has the puck in his own zone, 2:08 to play, and a 4-1 Kansas City lead. Arrows more set to center ice for Alan May. He'll dump the puck in and give chase as Drouville steered to the corner. Alan May is there, looks in front, trying to center it. Al May working hard along the boards. In behind the net, trying to send one in there. That is pushed away by Yo, and the Blades clear it out at center. 1:43 left, and a 4-1 Blade lead. Puck is at center, but intercepted by Dodie Wood, moving in with a shot, and that was stopped by Shabbat, and cleared out at center ice. Brian Stacey rolled one into the arrow end, and Kuchera is there. He's tied up by Emmons. And Kuchera back to play it. Darcy Wawrinka moves it up and out at center ice. Goes into Kansas City territory. DeRouville swats it along through Schuchat over to Dean Sylvester. It's cleared to center ice for Gary Emmons. Emmons moves it through the neutral zone and it goes into Arrow territory. Out of the net, Frederick Chabot, and Steve Jakes will play it. Under a minute to go, and a 4-1 Kansas City lead. Conroy shoots it in to Ruvel, trying to clear. Knocked down by Schuchat. Freer behind the cage, sets up. Waiting. Center, the shot stopped by DeRouville. And the Arrows have to go back with 39 seconds left.
You have to give the Blades defense so much credit tonight. They've been so solid in front of the net, knocking players down and clearing a path so that their goalie can see the puck.
Puck goes in. That is whistled down on an offsides play. 24 seconds to go, and a 4-1 Blade lead, and the Arrows are going to slip to 6-11-1. Long Beach and Utah just got underway. Kansas City will go to 6-7-4, and depending on how Manitoba is faring, let me see if I've got an update out of there. In the last we heard, Manitoba and Quebec tied at 2 midway through the second period. And let's take a look at tonight's Texaco star of the game, and you're looking at him, Philip DeRouville. At this point, he's faced 39 shots, 38 saves, had the play of the game. Anything else? I think we covered it.
And I think he's the likely fifth goaltender that has honored that award here.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you look at all the games we've had on Fox Sports Southwest and KKHT where we've picked a Texaco star of the game. I would have to venture about 80%. Our goaltenders, as the buzzer sounds, and this game is over. The Arrows fall to the Kansas City Blades by a score of 4-1. Don Jackson with a big road win to start off this eight-game swing. And the Blades congratulating Philip DeRouville as he continues with his excellent play.
And Friday night, I'm sure Larry Dick will not see the start. DeRouville will see the start. The Arrows are going to have to find a way tomorrow in practice to get traffic, to get better quality shots on this guy. They have to bury the puck.
Well, I guess the other thing you got to ask yourself, Troy Gamble, is what more can Dave Tippett do? I mean, you think you're going to make a stride after defeating Phoenix, and they came out, and I thought put forth a decent effort, not the same effort we saw against Phoenix, but they had a decent effort, but I think two glaring things stood out tonight. One were the numerous mistakes that resulted in quality scoring opportunities and or goals. And I think the second thing you look at it, I don't think you saw a very good Frederick Chabot tonight.
Well, obviously he was not on the top of his game. But I believe, and being a former goaltender, it goes back to that D-zone coverage. It was not as sharp. They get some good scoring chances. They buried the puck tonight. And it happened so quick, Adam. Cerrone blasts that shot off the far post. He makes a good shot. Maybe if Frederick Chabot is a little sharper, he makes the save. But still, that was a good shot.
Going to be an interesting practice tomorrow at the Aerodrome for the Houston Arrows as they try to regroup after this one. And it never really did get off to a very good start when Jason Cerrone got the first goal. 2:16 into the game, the Arrows never really could bounce back, although they did get some scoring chances. Philip DeRouville was terrific, and you can also mention he was the difference tonight as well. We talked about the Arrow mistakes, we talked about Frederick Chabot struggling, but the other thing is, a good effort tonight from Philip DeRouville.
Well, he just played so solid all night, and Rob Dobson, the one thing that he said when he talked to us tonight, Adam, is that he was in the position to make the save.
Troy, thank you very much for your help. Don't forget, the Arrows are back in action again Friday night right here at the Summit as they take on the Kansas City Blades. That will be a KKHT-only game. Next Fox Sports Southwest game will be Wednesday, November 20th against the Orlando Solar Bears. Stay with us on radio for the Arrows postgame highlight show. Once again, tonight's final score, the Kansas City Blades 4, Houston Arrows 1. Troy Gamble, this is Adam Gordon saying goodnight from the Summit.